head to head, you can't compete with me. It's no debate, you too fake, and it's too real with me. What's the topic? I'll block it, I keep that shield with me. Ammo loaded, I'm cocking, I got that steel with me. What you talking is nonsense, blow off your conscience. I'm a living sickness, Magic Johnson. By that action, no Bronson, I'm a King LeBron. And the whole league is fuck your feelings, who you thought it would be. Catch me in the streets, internet thugs just typing on keys. And the fans from Ticket TV sign that permission slip, please. That Max Ether gon' heat you, make you fall to your knees. No way out, this the firm, come near this stove, you gon' burn. Been waiting patient, now it's my turn. What Kevin say, today you gon' learn. True to the king, what's happening? You got the sauce, keep doing your thing. TKO, I'm from rounding the ring. I'm a god to you minions, but stay in your lane. Work it out, I cannot promise no favors. The panel is live, sports talk, sit down at the table. This the family, understand me, don't get it twisted. Shootin' won't miss it, we on a mission. Fuck your feelings, antisocial, what's the business, eh? We talk it, we live it, hold on, let's get it. Hold on, let's get it, eh? Gumbo strikes in the zebra, this for my people, gon' bring out the ether, eh? FYF, they know we too lit, they know we too lit. FYF, they can't do it like this, they can't do it like this. Fuck your feelings, it is what it is, it is what it is. We the realest, let's get turned in this bitch, let's get turned in this bitch.
FYO Sports, man. So, Mike, we back, man. Appreciate everybody pulling up. And what I want to make sure is I don't want to confuse any people in the chat. I see a couple of you guys hopped in here early, and you thought this was a live game. No. This is just a replay of last week's game. That's all. So, Kobe Talk Show, Memphis 10. For anybody that was wanting to pull up, man. I'm just going to really right now, before we even actually get started with the NBA film study, because that's what we ultimately going to be doing today, is we going to be replaying this game. And I think one of the worst things that you can do, and let me pull the chat up here so I can actually see it. All right, I got it right here. Oh, let me remove this. All right. Cool. So what I'm thinking is, look, one of the worst things that people have been doing is putting on like a false pretense on some of the things that have been going on surrounding LiAngelo Ball. That's the unfortunate reality. I think there are more people who are fans of his persona. There are more people who are fans of the Ball brand and the personalities that they want to see all of these players, Lonzo, Lamelo, LiAngelo, get to the highest league in the world, basketball league in the world, irregardless of hard work, talent, skill, and all the things that it takes to get to a league where there's only essentially 400 players. I mean, you have to be better than the top 1% to get into the NBA. And so when we evaluate players that can actually get NBA consideration, we have to nitpick all of the ins and outs of their game. And then we also have to analyze if you have the propensity to get better and evolve and develop your game so that you can ultimately one day be a player that can help a team win a championship. That's the ultimate goal. So we're going to be playing this game. We're going to go through the full game today. So for all the people that was watching, he says, is this the game where he scored 30 points? And so B1975, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be keeping track of all of the stats right here, because I've seen some people say he shot 12 for 36. Somebody said 15 of 45. Some people were saying he shot 4 of 15 from the three. Another person said 4 of 18. So what we're going to do is I'm going to keep track of all the stats. Makes, misses, three-point attempts, field goal misses, free throws. I'm doing all of that. Rebounds, assists, steals, turnovers, and blocks. And then what we also going to do is now, because we're not just going to talk about the game. See, I see a lot of people. I see a lot. He says, finally, man, missed the stream. What you mean, missed the stream? Oh, you missed my live streams. Oh, yeah. No, I'm going to be going back live. Look, I'm going to tell y'all right now. Like, I'm going to be straight up. I'll be honest with y'all. The reason why I've slowed down doing the live streams, I'm going to tell y'all the reason. Live streams are for the least the type of content that I want to put out. Live streams are not very, they're not valuable content because live streams are not very rewatchable. Now, a live stream like this might be more rewatchable than most, but for the most part, live streams aren't rewatchable and they don't help me get a lot of watch time. And when you don't get a lot of watch time, you don't get a lot of recommendations to and for new subscribers potentially. And so when you go in live over and over and over, the one thing happens is everybody, the only thing all the subscribers is wanted, they want for you to go live. And then secondly, you don't get a lot of channel growth. If you guys see, I've been doing more uploads, close to one upload per day. And we've went from 30K subscribers to over 40K in like a month. And so sometimes I have to fall back off strategies that aren't working. This is not to mention that some of y'all is cheap. I'll be doing 5 and 6 hour lives. And I only have $10 worth of donations throughout the live stream too. So that essentially, that means I'm making like $2 an hour messing with y'all in some of the live streams, man. So that's a lot of time we put out, but I will get back to doing the lives, man. I will be doing more lives. Also, there's a time consideration, right? Coaching, you guys know I'm doing a lot of other stuff. So I will be getting back to the lives. The majority of my lives, I'm actually going to transition all my FYF lives to our other channel, Whatever Happened to the News TV. I'm actually about to change that channel name to FYF Sports Lives, right? We're going to go do all of our lives over there, right? Because I can turn the monetization on over there. You guys can super chat, do all those things over there. That channel can be strictly for lives. So actually, before we get started here, I'm going to drop the link to that channel. I'm going to drop the link to that channel in the chat. Now, right now, the current name of the channel is Whatever Happened to the News TV. But we're going to change that channel name. We're going to kind of rebrand that channel. So make sure you guys sub up over there. If you guys are really looking for the lives, I'm going to be doing all my FYF Sports lives over there. And this channel is going to be primarily for uploads and live premiere videos. So that way we can kind of keep things separate. But today we're going to be playing this game. We're going to go ahead and play it. Remember, for the people that are coming in, what we're doing is, we are breaking down LiAngelo Ball's game with a fine tooth and comb. If you guys want me to stop it and replay something, I will. For the most part, I want to let it play through as much as possible. Right? He says, we giving Gelo some shine. Nah, we're not giving him some shine. This is called film study. And what we're going to do is we're going to call it honestly. I'm a tough critic. And the one thing with me is, on a daily basis, I see guys that don't get as much publicity as a LiAngelo Ball putting in a ton of work, not getting no recognition from nobody, right? I see guys out here grinding, going overseas, going down to Mexico, playing in 3-on-3 and 5-on-5 tournaments just to try to build up a name for themselves. Really, really grinding and putting in the work, right? When I look at, there's a guy that, who just graduated from Texas Tech. He's already been on 2 overseas tours, grinding. He was in summer league. I mean, I see people really grinding, trying to build a name for themselves just to get to the knee. So I'm not going to be one of the people that's going to be taking it easy on LiAngelo Ball, because like I said, when he can live comfortably over here, the pressure of having to provide for his family ain't there. It's guys out here that's going And if they don't win this tournament, if they don't win certain tournaments, they can't feed their family a certain week. LiAngelo can go home and drive Maserati, you know, he could drive all types of cars. He's living in a big mansion. He's a part of, he don't have the stresses of a lot of the players that's really putting in the grind. They live a very stressful lifestyle. So I'm not about to be one of the people that's going to come over here and be like, oh, awesome, he made a three. No, we're going to break the game down with a fine tooth and comb, just like we do everybody else. You know, we don't pity pat with basketball over here. Basketball's serious, man. All right? And just because you got the ball name on your back, that don't alleviate you from real criticism. Right? And I think that's where there's a divide happening here. There is a divide happening because what's happening is you have a sector of people looking to just be fans and not really talk about the game, honestly. And then you have people who are true basketball heads like me, where it's hard for me to listen to fandom to the degree where you're essentially lying to people. When I'm looking at chopped up highlights saying LiAngelo Ball put on the performance of the year, that's called a finesse. Now you finessing people who you think don't know the game of basketball. So this is one of the reasons why we about to do this film study. Ayo, two times said Lamont. Looking back at it, honestly, he said it's honestly dumb as fuck that LiAngelo even stole like he has. I mean, but see, and you know what, Ayo, I'm not one of the people that's going to get on him for that, because I'm a believer in, look, he was enrolled at UCLA for a reason, you guys. He was enrolled at UCLA for a reason as a three-star recruit. He wasn't even starting on that team. He makes a mistake. A lot of college basketball players make mistakes. They didn't kick him off the team. They didn't kick him out of the school. He just had to serve the time for committing a crime. And because of how publicized it was, what he did, right? Because of the stain that it put on the school. Because remember, he was with the school. He made the coaches look bad. He made the school look bad. Right. To a certain degree, he made the whole United States look bad when you go over to China and do that. And the only thing that they ask, you suspended for the season, which essentially would have been a red shirt year for him. So the coaches would have red shirted him. On top of him being red shirted, he would have got a COVID year as well. He would still be in college basketball, really developing his game. Right. And if he ever became NBA ready, he could go. But for him to, because he didn't want to serve the punishment for the crime that he committed, he thought it'd be best to go test his, you know, he thought, and I'm not even going to put this decision on LeVar, because it was LiAngelo's decision to leave school. He's a grown man. He left school. He chose to go all of these overseas ventures where he never stayed with a team for a full season. He laid this current bed that he's in. Played with the JBA a little bit, Lithuania a little bit, just a little bit of time here and there. No consistency. Come on, y'all. I'm just being honest. I always believed he would have been at least a 3 to 4 year college player who could have came out of college seasoned enough to be an NBA player. And he gave all of that up to go do what? And the only reason why you give that up, because if you go look at the other two guys that got caught stealing with them, those guys stayed in school. Why? Because they didn't have a luxury lifestyle to go home to if college don't work out. So the other two guys said, well, I don't got nothing better than this right here. I got to stay in school. So the other two guys stayed in school. One of the guys actually stopped hooping and is doing a rap career now, but the other guy's like overseas hooping. It's just the choices we make. We make these choices. So because he made that choice, I'm not going to run around and say the NBA's blackballing him. The NBA's not blackballing him. If anything, the NBA's given him more opportunities than most players based on what we've seen. Most players get one shot in the G League. most players don't get two stints in summer league and potentially two stints in the G League. When, especially in that first year, when you look, because we can go back to look at when we review how he did in the G League before, he wasn't a starter. His minutes were inconsistent. His three-point field goal shot was, I think, 35%. He shot 39% from the field. On top of the fact that his defensive rating was 121.9, the worst in the G League. But yet you're supposed to ask a person like me, FYF Sports Debates, you want me to go lie and say that this man is NBA ready. First of all, I'm a defensive-minded player. I love guys that play defense. And you about to tell me a guy with a 121.9 defensive rating belongs in the NBA? And that's in the G League. That's not even in the NBA. He says, nah, Lamont, LiAngelo should have followed LaMelo's pass. Ayo, two times. He was never LaMelo. He was never LaMelo. He was a three-star. LaMelo was a five-star player coming out of high school. Lonzo was a five-star player coming out of high school. It's levels to this. Do you guys know how many players lead their state in scoring and go D2? Just because you lead the state of California in scoring doesn't mean you're going D1. There are plenty of guys that go to prep schools, can average 10 points per game on a loaded prep school team and get a scholarship to Duke. If you just look at the guy named Dalen Terry played here in Arizona. He played for a prep school here in Arizona. He was only averaging like 12, 13 points per game. He wasn't putting up 30s and 40s, but he got a scholarship to Arizona, and then now he's in the NBA. Nobody cares if you're putting up 30 points a game in high school. That normally will never translate because nobody's ever going to ask you to be that type of scorer on the next level unless you're just otherworldly good. And that's only, and we know those players when we see them. I'm just saying, let's be honest. Let's just be realistic. Jimmer Fredette, J.J. Redick, these are guys that, Jimmer Fredette, I think he led the country in scoring one year. Nobody thought Jimmer Fredette was going to come into the NBA, leading the NBA in scoring. J.J. Redick led college basketball in scoring, but then only averaged 12 points a game in his NBA career and was a journeyman role player. I don't want to hear what you did in high school. Especially when a lot of the teams you were playing up until your senior year were hot garbage. So we're going to go ahead and get to this game because, again, I don't like people who, you know, again, there's a certain level of a grind that you have to put in the hoop. And I'm not going to give anyone with privilege any exception to the rule. LiAngelo's living a privileged life. He's had enough given to him. You're not getting any freebies from FYF Sports, man. We're going to keep it honest. We're going to be real. So when I do this breakdown, again, if you're a fan, if you're just a super fan that doesn't like hearing anything negative, you're in the wrong place. I'm going to call it down the line. I'm going to be fair. If it's positive, I'm going to call it positive. If it's average, I'm going to call it average. And if it's trash, we're going to call it trash. He said if his dad wasn't LeVar, he wouldn't be in the league. I mean, in the G League. I don't know. I don't want to keep bringing up LeVar because LiAngelo is now, 23, 24 years old? Something like that? Why we keep bringing up LeVar like he's a little kid still? This man's making all his choices on his own. LaMelo is much younger. And you know what LaMelo woke up and said? I'm about to go sign with Puma. I'm tired of doing this BBB brand stuff. That's what he said. I'm about to start my own clothing line. These are grown men we talking about. So I don't know why y'all keep bringing up LeVar as if LiAngelo don't have control over his own situation. When he does, he has full control over everything that's going on right now. So all the decisions, all of the things good or bad that are happening are LiAngelo's fault. Nobody else's. You can't keep running around blaming LeVar. Or acting like LeVar has something to do with it. Give credit where credit is due. He said he was another highly touted player. I don't know. But let's go ahead and get to this game. Yeah, look, we playing around. Hold on. I'm going to turn the volume down on this game. If you guys want the game sound up, just let me know. I'll turn it up some more. But I'm about to go ahead and play this game, man. Remember, this is the game from last week. But we're going to be covering. We're going to be covering all the stats. Points, rebounds, assists, steals, blocks, turnovers. Right? So we can have a true and accurate assessment of what he did this game. That's what we're going to do. All right. He said, dude, it's a scrub, Celtics Lord said. I mean, again, I'm going to tell you this right here. Last year in the summer league, LiAngelo was not playing like a scrub. He came out in shape. He was defending. He looked lighter. He was getting his shot off quicker. I thought that was his prime opportunity to get to the league. He came out this year looking slow, like he gained a few pounds, out of shape. G League, I mean, the Charlotte Hornets G League coach said he was a bit out of shape as well, not ready to go. Come on, man. All right, we got the game right here. And remember, we're going to be doing a full breakdown. I'm going to stop it if I see some BS, man. If y'all want the game sound up, let me know. I can turn the game sound up, but again, I want y'all to make sure y'all can hear me.
Starting off strong.
Jordan Beal with the quick dunk to start the game off right off the tip.
Lamont, do you think he's serious about basketball? And look, he's a shot chucker.
With the missed three.
He chucked up a three right there. Hold on. We got 0 for 1. He missed a three right there, so we got 0 for 1 right there. Looking at all stats.
Big time three. Chapter 5-6-2 is starting off pretty strong.
All right, KJ.
Turnover right there, LiAngelo. So we got one turnover and one missed three so far. I don't know if he's serious about basketball. But it's not really looking like they're taking it very seriously with this team they brought to the Drew. Okay. Missed shot right there. We got a rebound and a putback. So he makes a two-point shot. He gets a rebound. But he also missed a shot. He also missed a two.
For everybody just tuning into the Drew League for the first time, let me get you guys together with how the season is going for these two teams. We got BBB.
He says, am I thinking of Tracy McGrady?
Seven.
Hey, salute to Anthony, man. Appreciate you guys, man.
First win in Chapter 5-6-2 is 5-3.
I know, you know, LaVar Ball, obviously the head coach of Big Baller Brand. I know how competitive he is, so I know how much he wants to get.
All right, Big Baller team with the ball, man. All right, LiAngelo chucks up another three, misses another three. So there's another three-point miss right there. Remember, y'all, he's not putting the ball on the ground much. So again, that tells me right there. Again, when you just shot chucking like that, you either injured and or you don't feel comfortable handling the ball. But chucking up a fall away three from the corner, not a good shot.
Fast start here by.
Hey, and true story about this team that they're playing, this Chapter 5 team. Outside of Jordan Bell, this is a group of guys. They all work at FedEx. So when you talk about a team literally playing mailmen, these LiAngelo's literally playing mailmen in this game. Literally. This is a group of guys that all work at FedEx together that put this team together. All right, LiAngelo with the ball. They're force feeding on the ball every time he gets it. Fade away, misses a fade away right there. So he missed a horrible fade away shot where he's again turning his back to the basket. All right, slings the ball up the court. All right, almost with the assist, he don't get it. Not comfortable with the ball. He doesn't put the ball on the floor. He tosses it to a big. Could have been potentially a good pass, but it wasn't. Big baller team with the ball, getting it up the court right now.
Big time steal, fast break.
So they're getting blown out pretty good already, early into this game. No, I'm not joking, AO two times. I'm not joking. This is a true story. I was reading about it on Twitter.
All
All right, so right now we got LiAngelo Ball has 5 missed shots right here. And they went back to this horribly ran trap and press. Again, I don't know. I wouldn't even listen to LeVar at this point if he's telling me to trap in the Drew League. I'm not doing it. Because this is just gonna open you up to getting embarrassed. All right, so LiAngelo right now has 2 points, 1 rebound, and 1 turnover. That's what he has with 5 misses so far. He does cherry pick too much, so Celtics lore. See, he cherry picks way too much, and it's just a bad sign, man. All right, so LiAngelo in the post once again. All right, horrible decision to go trap right here. You strong side. Well, idiot, why would you go trap? The trap needs to come from the weak side. They swing it up the court. LiAngelo with a 3. Knocks the 3 down. All right, so we got LiAngelo with 5 points, 1 rebound, 1 turnover. Right, he's sprinting up the court, getting close to cherry picking every time. LiAngelo with a steal right there, and then turns it over. So he gets a steal, and then another turnover. So I remember I was on another channel. People were saying that this team was losing early because of the others. But early into this game, this is the first quarter, LiAngelo already has 2 turnovers. So he has 5 points, 1 rebound, 1 steal, and 2 turnovers. He says, Premium Bozo says, please, FYF, stop, I'm jealous. Okay. I guess I'll be that premium. Okay, so we got a bad trap right here that's probably going to expose them to gaps. Nobody has a real assignment. Oh, look, y'all. Look. This is – let me take this back a notch. I'm going to tell y'all, this is why you don't trap guys that hoop, that at least know what they're doing. Look at this. It's a horrible trap already. I don't know what they're doing. All right. Look how easy it is for this team just to move the ball around, find the gaps. I mean, they missed a shot right here. That could have been a highlight reel dunk. He misses the dunk. But it tells you right here that this team is not worried about them doing any type of trap or press. It's a very, very, like, I call it a junk defense to try to trap at this level. You only do it late game when you're trying to come back in desperation. Oh, Gelo on the drive. Step back 3. Misses another 3. So we have a 3-point miss right there. So right now he is 2-for-6. From the field. All right, LiAngelo, what are you doing? Oh, man, they're getting blown out. Oh, he swings it up court. We got LiAngelo with the ball on the drive. Turn around, fadeaway. Can he get it to go? Knocks it down off the glass. So right now in the first quarter, he is at 7 points right now. He said, this is pretty much, yeah, but you can even, but now that high school start, is that a turnover there? Turnover there right there. So on the field goal attempt, so he missed it with the turnover. So 3 turnovers in the first quarter so far. All right, ball's up the court. They get the steal. A good take right there. Oh, Sky, right now he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So he's 3-for-9 right now. 3-for-9. LiAngelo missed the shot. Oh, LiAngelo with the ball. I think he makes that one. Rattles it in. Good shot.
Yes, on a Saturday. I love it.
I don't know why they don't keep the scoreboard up. I think with the scoreboard, they'll put it up like every now and then. Get in a stance, man. Look like you want to defend. What are y'all doing? All right. Okay, entry pass. Is that an assist? No. I don't know. This BBB team, the body language, though, for a lot of these guys is look like they don't want to be there. For this game to be televised on the NBA app, on NBA.com, I'm talking about, I would be locked in playing some of the best defense and offense that I've ever seen. I'm not going to allow my team to get embarrassed. Ghost says, who do you think Trez and Schroeder? He says, why do you think Trez and Schroeder haven't been signed? I mean, I think those guys will get signed. I think right now teams are more so trying to figure out the bottom of their roster. Your young guys, two-way contracts, things like that, who they going to invite into training camp. Look at guys overseas. I don't know why they setting up in this press again. All right. And it looks like just the way they're moving the ball around that they're probably going to score as they score right there. Look, I'm on. Look, I could pause it right there. Look, we just run it back right here. Why are we pressing? Like, why did they even press? I think LeVar just wanting them to get embarrassed? I don't know if he wants them to get embarrassed. This team ain't even breaking a sweat. Look at the press. So first of all, I'm going to tell you guys a little something about the press. Okay, so ball goes through the hoop, you set your press up. So first of all, if you're going to run a trap and press, which is what they were doing, first thing you got to do is you got to put somebody on the goddamn ball so he can't throw a direct pass to the middle of the court. In any press, the worst place the ball can be is in the middle of the court. They don't put nobody on the ball. So this guy, what the worst thing that can happen to a press happens on the first pass because he has them running some dumb press. I can't tell if it's zone, man, trapping. Whatever it is, it ain't working. Get the ball to the middle of the court. All right. So then they let the ball get up the court. They move it around for a couple of passes. Second problem is that they don't even have a plan after they press. Are you dropping into zone? Are you dropping into man? It looks like they dropping into scramble. I don't know who the hell I got mode. Because now this dude drives, literally just walked into the game, hits a wide open floater. That's what I'm saying. If I'm going to be televised on NBA.com, why don't you just come out and play better with a better plan? Salute to LTTV, man. Appreciate you pulling up. Yeah, the press. A press with no pressure. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I don't get it. Look at this. Another dumb trap. Look, and I'm not going to stop it too many times, y'all, because once again, they've set up in literally the worst press that I've ever seen. I mean, if anything, just go man-to-man matchup full court. If you don't know what the hell you're doing. Look at this. Nobody on ball. So this dude right here with the ball is literally just selecting, okay, where's the open guy and I'm about to hit him. So they get the ball in. So look, they're going to try to trap. Horrible trap. I don't even remember this play out. I bet they score. Just because of how bad the press was, just because of how bad the effort is these guys are giving defensively, including LiAngelo. Whipped it around. Does he knock it down? Knocked down three. I told you.
5 points in the first 1 minute.
LiAngelo with the ball in the post. Misses a two-point shot right there, so he misses the layup. This guy comes down. Damn, this dude is from flyer right there.
Right now, Shay.
So he knocked down a three.
He must know the game is on the NBA.com right now. NBA app.
Yeah, the other team know it's on NBA.com.
Give it back to him.
There
you
go again.
Oh. Let me pause it. We got look, we gotta pause it. Look. Look at Dex pulling up. He says, I'm obsessed with BBB negative impact. No, I'm not. Because I've done how come you wasn't showing up when I was doing the videos in support of LeVar, in support of LiAngelo? I didn't. When these guys deserve it, I give it to them. When they don't, I have to ether them. I can't get mad because I call it down the line. I told y'all, all you got to do is look at my catalog. I've done videos in support of LeVar when the media tried to go at him. I've done videos in support of LaMelo when a lot of the college talking heads on ESPN were saying he wasn't that guy. I've done videos in support of Lonzo when everybody was down on him in 2020, especially after the bubble. I got videos on all this. But I can't act like I'm blind to what I'm seeing right here. So again, Dex, you can play like that, like ain't nothing wrong with Jello game. I'm not about to play the game. I'm going to call it down the middle. I don't choose sides. I have no side. I don't have any investment into BBB. I got a few of the shirts and hoodies and stuff. Outside of that, I'm not connected to him where I can't. And even if I was connected to him, even if I did know him, I'm still doing this video because I'm going to call it down the line. Thank you, 3 Glock. He says, Lamont is cooked tea. I'm saying, and people on Ticket TV will be killing me about supporting LeVar Ball and them. So don't act like I'm hating on them because I'm watching the game. I'm not saying, hey, I want you to ask y'all in the chat. Did I say Jello was ugly? Did I say I hate light skins or something? Because that's hating. Everything that I'm saying is the game. I can't control what these fools are doing on the court. What you mean? Oh, we gonna well, look. We gonna play. Look, I can't control this nonsense that we're saying. Look at this. Look at this. I can't control that he just chucked up a stupid ass 3-pointer like that. How do I control that? We gonna run it back. Now, what do y'all want me to say? What do y'all want me to say when I see a shot like that go up? I don't know how to call it. That was a dumb shot. What you want me to do? Look, it literally just happened. That's crazy. It was right there. So, homie knocks down the 3. Oh, no, he missed that one. Look at this. He's two to three steps behind the NBA 3-point line, and he's being guarded by an NBA player. What does he do? He doesn't put the ball on the floor. I want y'all to look. I want y'all to look. Look under the basket, y'all. Ain't nobody defending the rim. If he throws an up fake and drives, he probably gets the layup. That's a fact. What does he do, y'all? Now, what do y'all want me to say about that? So I got to mark it down. One is another missed 3. So he chucked up a horrible 3-point shot when the rim was wide open. So what you want me to do? I'm not calling him ugly. I'm not saying he broke. I'm not throwing your mama jokes at him. Right? What? I'm just talking about the game. Y'all getting mad at me because he chucks up these dumb shots. He says, everything LiAngelo do wrong. He ain't done nothing right. What you? If he does something right, I'm going to say, that was nice. Hey, y'all. We in the first quarter, Dex. He might do something good where I can be like, damn, that was nice. But he ain't done nothing nice. What you want me to do? I cannot make stuff up. See, Dex, you can say these things because you don't play the video alongside some of the things that you say. All I'm doing is playing the video. And if I see it, I see it. If I don't, I can't say it. I don't know what you want me to do, man. Now, Dex, what you can do, if y'all want me to go all positive, just if you want me to go all positive for the rest of this video, Dex, if you hit my Cash App with a good $200, and I'll switch my tone, and I'll just start capping for the rest of the video. Hold on, let me drop the Cash App for Dex. Now, if you incentivize me to cap, I cap. Now, Dex, there you go. If you incentivize me to just start making up stuff that ain't actually happening, there you go. There's the Cash App right there. Is anybody in the chat, if you drop $200 right now, I will switch my tone. Let's see if y'all really willing to pay the price, right? Dex, are you going to pay the price? And I'll switch my tone. If you pay the price, I'm going to act like I'm blind and I'm not watching the game. Everything that happened, I'm just going to disregard it. All the basketball knowledge, I'm going to shut it down. I'm going to act like I'm just a newbie to this. I'm waiting, man. I ain't seen a dollar sign pop up yet. Hold on. Now, see? If you want me to act blind, you got to pay me to be blind. But if y'all want me to be honest, then I'm going to continue playing a video, Dex. So, if you feel like I'm hating, I'm giving all the people that think I'm hating, I'm giving you a way out. I'm giving you ways to change the tone of me telling the truth, and I can fake it for the rest of the video. All right, 3 Glock 9 said he's not paying, so we're going to get back to it. I ain't think so.
You got chapter 5, 6, 2, oh, 31, Jordan Bill. 8.
God damn.
Two-hand flush.
They showing out now.
Yes, yes, yes.
LeVar might gotta call it.
Salute to Nicholas Brown, man. One of the elite moderators of FYF Sports, man. All right, man. I'm looking for something positive, man. LiAngelo posting up. I thought y'all said he was being a point guard.
Demo.
All right.
Dex, just say you don't want to come off that 200. Just say you don't want to come off the 200, Dex.
Just like you stepped out of bounds.
All right.
It'll be triple B's ball.
See, look. Now, I'm going to give you, look. I'm going to act like Dex for like 1 second. Watch this. Watch this.
All
right. Here, I'm going to play it. I saw something that Dex and them would point out and they would go crazy over. Watch this. So watch this. This is something that they would point out. Oh, Gelo sprinting back. Watch. This is what Dex would say. Gelo running back pretty hard. Watch out. Guys, I'm going to act like Dex for like 10 seconds. So I'm Dex right now. And guys, I want you guys to watch how... we got to use big words. How would Dex say this? Gelo is exasperating every ounce of energy to continuously run back multiplicative times to help this BBB team stay afloat in the Drew League. I want you guys to watch how he runs back. Look at Gelo. He's tired. He's exasperated. And he still sprint back, y'all. That's Dex. I can't be Dex, y'all. I can't do that. I can't see the game like that, man. I can't do that. He said, look how many empty seats. But hold on. I can swear y'all said the Swarm got him there for money. The last time I checked, it was free to get in the G League. And I see a lot of empty seats. How come ain't nobody there to see Gelo? I mean, I know why they not there. Come on, man.
Seconds left in the first quarter.
All right, man. First quarter's about to end. We're going to keep it playing. We'll keep playing. And then I'm going to tell you the first quarter stats. Gelo on the drive kick out. More than two dribbles, so no assist if he scores.
Nice move. It looked pretty good.
It looked pretty good, yeah. I love the attempt.
He said he got me. Dex, I'm just. All right, hold on. Did Gelo score? Bucket at the end of the quarter right there for Gelo.
You can hear head coach LeVar on the sideline begging for the foul call on that play.
And hopefully they show the score so we can give a score update.
Quarter three. Too strong. But they get the rebound.
Bernard with the rebound.
Does he knock it down? Dude's been on fire. Whoever little homie is, that homie right there is a shooter. Now he catching his shots. And he ain't needed 19 shots to get there. LiAngelo, does he make it go? No, he misses a fadeaway at the buzzer.
Final score for the first quarter. We got 36, chapter 562 to 22, BBB.
Yes. What's your...
All right, so 36-22. Now, after the first quarter, I'm going to give you guys a rundown of the stats. I've been keeping track of the stats, y'all. LiAngelo, right now, he's attempted... He attempted 15 shots in the first quarter, and he made 5 of them. So in the first quarter, how am I hating Josh Jackson? I'm just telling the stats. In the first quarter, he's 5 of 15 from the field, and he has 2, 4, 6, 8. He's 11 points on 15 shots. And he has 1 rebound, 1 steal, and 3 turnovers. He has 0 assists. That's the first quarter. So, look, y'all, this is the video. This ain't me giving anybody that's been listening since we started this, it's not me. I am just watching the video and I'm writing down the stats. Why y'all getting mad at me? Because I'm replaying the game. Y'all get mad at me. Now, see Josh Jackson, there you go with Dex. Y'all say I'm a hater. So, me saying that he's 5 of 15, I know that's hard on your ears, but that's called facts, Josh Jackson. Right. So far he's missed. So he's 1 of 5 from the 3-point line in the first quarter. 1 of 5. So, Dexterious Crockett says, "All y'all against me. I'm realizing you're not behind no enemy lines. I'm not, Dex. Maybe you can learn something. Look, this is really not a true film study because I'm really not breaking him down. I'm just taking the stats down, and I just told you guys how trash of a press they was running. That was clearly obvious to anybody. It was multiple people in here saying it looked like a horrible AAU press. That's what it looked like. Well, I'm going to keep it playing. We got to get to the second quarter.
They have more. Chapter 562 has more than just Jordan Bell. What right. we're learning in the second half of the first quarter was Bernard Johnson didn't come to play.
He did not come to play.
Over on the NBA.com.
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Let me show you what I got.
He didn't got her. He probably got this morning. Shay phone.
Josh. Hold on, Josh. Why do y'all keep saying he needs more consistent minutes? That ain't how it work. If you trash, the coach ain't playing you. If you nice, you get played. Can y'all imagine? I'm going to pause for a second. Can y'all imagine the bench player at Duke walking up to Coach K saying, if I just had more minutes, man, I could do what Jason Tatum's doing. You know what Coach K going to play? Take your ass back to the end of the goddamn bench. And if you show out in practice, I might give you a little look. I might put you in at the end of the game. That's not how this thing works, man. Everybody sitting on the bench in a basketball game thinks they should be in. I don't care how trash you are. Everybody thinks they can go in a game and do what the stars do. And it don't work like that. It's roles. And role players, unfortunately, don't get a ton of minutes. Role players have to be able to come in short bursts, do what you do. You don't have time to be like, coach, leave me in. I need more minutes. Get your ass on this goddamn bench. That's what the coach going to say. The starter's about to go back in and handle the heavy lifting. I told you, this is not kindergarten basketball where everybody has to get equal amount of playing time. That's not what this is. And if he's really, truly concerned about playing time, then he would force one of these teams to sign him to a two-way or Exhibit 10 contract before he steps on the court. Other than that, man, he's just out there. He just welcoming abuse. He's just welcoming all the abuse that he's getting from the swarm team, not playing him and all that stuff. He must enjoy it. Let's play this. He need more playing time. I ain't never heard nobody say that. Hey, coach, I need more playing time. Coach, my defensive rating is 121.9, but I need more playing time. Sit your ass on the goddamn bench. Come on, man. So 36-22 in the first quarter, y'all. Not the first half, the first quarter. Lamont addressed Josh and I because he knows. Nah, y'all the only ones talking that nonsense. Gelo with a three. Knocks it down. That's it. That was a good three. Even though he hasn't put the ball on the ground, that was a good three. Maybe the second quarter is going to be the quarter where Dex and Josh Jackson can prove us wrong. Do they make a comeback? See, this is where if I start a quarter off like that, whatever LeVar has been telling me, I'm about to start blocking out everything he say, because we got to keep this run going. Because the more he try to coach them, this shit's gonna go in the trash. LeVar needs to sit down and stop trying to be a coach. As a businessman, LeVar is a beast. But as a coach, LeVar Ball is hot garbage. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and play this. All right, let's see if they can capitalize on the 4-0 run to start the quarter. Gelo, you better get in help defense, Gelo. That's on you. Nope, he missed it. That was Jello's missed assignment there, if you're actually watching the film. Gelo, with the handle. Hold on. Hey, Flight, I seen you in the chat. Flight, did Bone Collector teach him that? Because Flight is the one talking about Bone Collector. Put that man back in the game. Flight, did Bone Collector teach him that bullshit? Is that the triple threat that you was talking about? He let a FedEx worker take the ball from him. I told you, this team, I want y'all to go look it up. This team is comprised of a group of guys that all work at FedEx together. Literally mailmen. Watch this. Clamps up. So I like the way this guy's playing defense. Why? Because this guy's doing something called one pressure, but he also has a no middle stance. He He says, I'm not letting you drive middle. We're going to see what your handles is like. And when he sees that, he don't want to put the ball down, because the only thing that Gelo's done in this game so far is just catch and throw up some a lot of bad threes. So let's see. And I gotta write down the turnover, because he did lose the ball. So we're going to go here. We're going to play it. Because the homie just took the ball from him. Give me that. Let me get that shit. Get your ass out the way. That's basically what he said. Get in the stands, Gelo. Get in the help, Gelo. Nope. No stands, no help. And he jogs back. Hey, he did jog back hard, though. Gelo did jog back hard than a motherfucker. Gelo in the corner. Puts the ball on the floor. Okay. Nothing right there. Please don't set that press up. Please don't set the press up. Oh, man. God, ball gets right to the middle of the floor. Damn. What kind of press is it that y'all running and you don't got the middle of the floor covered? What kind of press is that? How you have a press and you don't have nobody at half court protecting the middle of the floor? The whole purpose of a press is to not let the ball up the middle of the floor. Dex said, what piqued your interest in the Drew League? When they said LeBron was playing in that motherfucker. And when DeMar DeRozan was playing. And when I seen Malachi Flynn was hooping in it. I follow more than just these guys. It's a lot of guys, overseas guys that I follow, that are hooping in the Drew League. And I've been a fan of the Drew League for years, y'all. From back when Denzel Valentine got cooked by Frank Nitti. LiAngelo with the post, kicks it out. Can he get an assist? No assist for Gelo yet. No assist for Gelo yet this game, y'all. So I want y'all to watch how they try to finesse his numbers, because he has zero assists so far. They set up this two-man horrible press, and they get the ball right to the... Oh, they covered it. What's his name? Tried to cover it, but he gets blown by. Uh-oh. They left him wide open.
Can he do it again?
Oh, he missed a three, though. He says, FYF won't analyze them good Gelo games. What good Gelo? Josh Jackson, send me a link of a good game, and I'll analyze it. Hold on. And Josh Jackson, didn't y'all say this was a good game? Y'all said he dropped 33. What you mean it's not a good game? So Josh, are you admitting this wasn't a good game? Uh-oh, post. Oh, yeah, that was a travel. Good call, ref. That was a good call. I don't know what y'all want me to do. Y'all said this was a good game. Then you say you want me to go back and watch when he plays good. I thought y'all said he played good, man. All right, Gelo with the post on the smaller defender. Can he finish him off? Help comes. He almost loses it. Oh, he does turn the ball over. Oh, does he turn it over? Nope. Ooh, could have been another turnover. Could have been another turnover. So now they're getting mad because I'm reviewing a game that they said was Gelo's good game. Gelo with the kick out. Can he get an assist? He has no assist yet, man. That was a good kick out, though. Strong side pass. He kicked it to the strong side like he was supposed to when the defender helped. Gelo just scrambling over the court. Gelo, come back and play defense. Get back and play defense, Gelo. Oh, my. Now, see, I want y'all to look, y'all. Look at this, y'all. Am I doing this? Is it me? Or did Gelo cherry pick so goddamn hard that he allowed his man to hit a three? Look at this sequence, y'all. Is this me? Or is this Gelo doing it? Okay, now look, we're going to play it. Gelo giving sloppy contest and closeout. Gelo gone. Gelo done took off. Gelo just took off on his team. So for all the people running around talking about all these other guys is scrubs, they losing because all these other guys ain't doing nothing. It's four guys right here. None of them named LiAngelo Ball trying to play defense as best as they can against five guys. I want y'all to see this. No Gelo. Gelo still ain't came back into play. His man came back into play to do what? His man came back into play to do what, y'all? Knock down a wide open three. But I can't. I'm supposed to ignore that. Now, if Dex would have paid me $200, I wouldn't have pointed that out. You guys might have noticed it, but I wouldn't have pointed it out. Gelo with a cross-court pass. That is one of the worst passes in basketball. Cross-court pass and transition. Can he get the fadeaway to go? He misses another turnaround fadeaway. All right. Now, all I'm doing is just reporting the game as I see it. Y'all cannot get mad at me. Celtics Lord says he's a scrub. He's playing like a scrub. I don't know if he is a scrub, but he is playing like one.
I don't know. LeVar might need a new strategy.
And thank you, Kobe Talk Show.
One player on the bench. So.
Just go overseas.
Actually, you know, I'm sure they knew they were coming with a small team, but it looks like they might need adjust a little bit because Chapter 562 came ready to play.
Memphis, they don't want to hear that. When I was all positive about LiAngelo, they wasn't even liking the video. I'm just calling the game how I see it. If I miss something positive, I want y'all to tell me in the chat. If I miss something that positive that happens, I will rewind it and reemphasize it. All right, Gelo. Gelo gets the ball. Gelo loses it right there. Now, I got to rewind that because I don't know if that's a turnover on him. I don't know if LiAngelo had full possession right there. We got to see if he had full possession. Did he have possession? No, he didn't have possession. So I can't give that turnover to LiAngelo. They're running that crazy trap. Oh, he missed a layup, though, man. You got to finish that. Good defense. Good defense. Hold on, y'all. Now, he did dunk the ball, y'all. But watch this. Watch this, y'all. I want y'all to see something. Because once again, this is a tendency that's going to get LiAngelo probably cut from a G League team. What's going on right now, y'all? I see two guys down here battling for a rebound, right? Because the blue team still has the ball right now. I want you guys once again to watch what LiAngelo Ball does. Because earlier this got him burned. His team is battling down low for the rebound. Blocking shots, contesting the shot. Block shot right there. Where's LiAngelo? His team is not trash. From what I'm seeing, his team is out here playing both sides of the floor. I see one guy right here who ain't stepped. This Gelo on this play did not go inside the three-point line. On a play where there was a loose ball and guys were fighting for position for a rebound, he didn't even go inside the painted area. He took off down court to do what? To cherry pick for buckets. Which he does get the dunk here. And this is a left-hand dunk. You give him credit for that. Right? Left-hand dunk. He cherry picked a bit. But this point was essentially created by the hustle of his team. So when people start running around saying his team was trash, his team is doing all the heavy lifting. And he's just trying to reap the benefits of their work by leaking out every time. Again, when I say that, is that just me talking? Is that just me talking? Or did the video prove that? I want y'all to ask me. This is not me being, this is not even criticism. I'm literally just explaining what happened in the video. Gelo with the dunk, though. We got to mark that down. They running this press again. Looks like they sagged off. Oh, man. They still got the ball. All right. Gelo, what are you doing? Come on, man. You got to D up. All right. Transition. Are you going to get him the ball? Air ball. That looked horrible when it left his hands. That looked horrible. Oh, Flexway, what's good, man? Hey, me and Flex Sweatman, we had a workout today, man. I'm on a 90-day plan trying to get right. I'm going to drop his IG in the chat for y'all if y'all want to check him out.
We got about 4 minutes left.
Thank you, Sky. It's not, the video is proving all this. This is why I'm playing the full game, Sky. This is why I'm not cutting nothing up. Uh-oh, we got Gelo on the post up once again.
Hook shot.
He gets the worst hook shot in basketball history to not fall. Hold on. Let's get this miss down. So we just saw the worst hook shot in basketball history. Not fall.
Down to LiAngelo trying to get in the paint.
And this is what happens when you're undersized 6'5 guy that's out of shape and you don't want to take your ass on the perimeter to be a guard, and you sitting there on the block trying to post guys up like you Hakeem Olajuwon. Man, you gotta stop this nonsense. I got you, Celtics lore. I got you. Here you go right there. Alright, let me make Flex Sweat a mod real quick. Hold on, can I make him a mod? Flex Sweat, I'm gonna make you a mod so you can drop your YouTube channel or your IG in the chat. Salute to Flex Sweat, man. And drop your TikTok as well, because Flex Sweat be dropping some gems on TikTok, man. We had a real good conversation about cryptocurrencies today during the workout, man. Might do a full live stream about it. All right, but we're gonna get back to the video, man. Salute to Flex Sweat. Flex Sweat for pulling up.
All right.
All right, we got guys walking back on defense. And remember, this is all on NBA.com. This is a game that's being televised by the NBA. All right, back in transition. So right now, while we're on a timeout, y'all. While we're on a timeout, we're going to run through the stats. Okay, we're going
to
run through the stats. So right now he's 7 of 19. He's 7 of 19, one rebound, one steal, and four turnovers. Those are the stats. He says, so you don't see that Gelo absorb all that man's body weight? That's a foul. What you mean absorb, Dex? What the hell does that even mean? Absorb somebody's body weight and that's a foul? What are you talking about, man? That man didn't get fouled. He's 6'5", trying to throw up hook shots in the post. I want y'all to tell me what other guard in the league is 6'5", throwing up hook shots in the post. Come on, man. Talk about absorbed his weight, making it a foul. What you mean absorbed his body weight? Absorbed. I don't even know what that means. That's not even a basketball. You can't tell that to nobody in basketball where it could be understandable. I don't care what coach you bring up from history. It don't make no sense. Absorbed his body weight. Now that's a foul. I want y'all, anybody that hoops, next time you in a game and you get fouled, I want you to walk to the ref and be like, ref, I absorbed that man's body weight, man. Call the foul next time. I want y'all to say that to the ref. He might just give you a tech or something just for saying that dumbass shit. Come on, man. Can't believe you just said that, Dex. Absorbed a man's body weight. Now it's a foul. All right, but we got to get back to these stats, because stuff like that is going to make me miss a lot of this. So it looks like they're in some type of, are they in man or zone? All right, so we got LiAngelo. Okay, he's helping off. He's helping off. Is he protecting the corner? Sprint out.
KJ.
All right. I don't know what the hell they got going on right there.
Laku, back down for three.
Uh-oh, here you go. They ball of breath starting to cut to that lead. 34 to 45.
So it's not really too bad. It's 34-45 right now. I think they're in a 2-3 zone.
Knock that one down.
KJ said, uh-uh.
Why a 2-3 zone in the Drew League? Oh, almost another turnover. It was a turnover. Hold on. I don't want to give this turnover to LiAngelo if it wasn't him. So we got to go back and check. I need to see if the guy that he threw the ball to had full possession. If he didn't have full possession, then that's a turnover on LiAngelo. So hold on. I don't know. You guys tell me, because I don't know. I'm not a statistician. It didn't look like he had full possession. Because it didn't look like he had both hands on the ball. So I got to give that turnover. I'll put a question mark by it. But that's in the official books, that has to be a turnover. Jay Smitty, he says he out there absorbing body weight. Now he absorbing body weight. I want him to go to Steve Clifford. Hey, Steve Clifford, one of my best skill sets, I can absorb body weight. I need a roster spot. Y'all think that'll work? I want to see Gelo get on national TV and tell people how he absorbs body weight on a basketball court. Come on, man. Yeah, that was a turnover. I got it down as a turnover. And they're not playing defense. And one. Nope. No, and one. Josh, but the turnover goes to the passer. The turnover always goes to the passer. If the guy doesn't catch it. I'm just going off how stats are taken, Josh Jackson. You got to get out your feelings. It's not me. We'll look it up. We'll look up the definition of how you notate these things. But based on my understanding of the game, that's a turnover on Gelo because he threw the pass and the guy couldn't catch it. It was a bad pass to begin with. But, again, if you're Gelo, if you have a higher IQ, you're just going to throw the ball off the nearest man to you and just let it go out of bounds. And you reset the possession. It don't have to be his fault for it to be a turner over on him, Josh Jackson. You guys should know this from Lamelo. Sometimes Lamelo ball's turnover numbers are up because guys can't hold on to the goddamn ball. Like Cody Zeller couldn't. And Lamelo will get attributed with those turnovers. It's just how it goes. It's unfortunate, but it happens. It's just a turnover, Josh Jackson. It'll be all right. Remember, Josh Jackson, you said he played a good game. So this is his good game right here. So we analyzing the good game. That's all we doing. We just watching the game over. Enjoy. Oh, good pass. Does he get an assist? Oh, okay. One assist on the game. We'll rewind it too, man. Because I know Josh Jackson and Dex. Every time there's a good play, I'm going to replay it. And then I'm going to react to it like I'm Dex. All right? So we got to react to this like I'm Dex. So how would Dex react to it? All right. Dex was going to say LiAngelo with the ball. And how would Dex define this? Dex would say, how would Dex say this? We got to think of, he would say, I don't know, man. Dex uses so many confusing words, man. Somebody got to help me. How would Dex over-exaggerate that basic pass? How would he over-exaggerate it, man? But it was a good pass, though. All right, that was a good pass. And a great finish by Big Homie who dunked the ball. But he did get his first assist of the game as they are in some weird zone. And I don't know what they got going on defensively. But that was a good pass, y'all. No cap to that. There was a good pass. I ain't gonna cap on that. You laser it in. He wasn't indecisive with it. And the big man actually finished, man.
Very rested.
Yeah, Steve Nash level passing. What are we going to say now? I think Dex would say he might have the potential to be the next Magic Johnson. All right, they advance the ball up. Are they looking for Gelo? Gelo with the ball. Does he put it on the ground? Deep three right there. God damn. What the hell? Put the ball. Gelo, these are FedEx workers. These are not NBA players. Drive on them. He misses another three, though, badly. We'll replay it, though. So Gelo with the ball. He's seeking out his shot. He gets the ball. Step back three. So he's 2 to 3 steps behind the NBA three-point line. He shoots a contested fadeaway three. Misses badly. But his teammate recovers and puts it back in for him. Get in a stance. Get in help. Yeah, my God. God, bro. Their defense is hot garbage. Oh, they sling it up to Gelo. Turnover. I mean, not a turnover, but just a bad, almost a turnover on the on little homie who passed the ball. Uh-oh. Corner three. Misses a corner three. Oh, my God. Now. So, I got to mark the three now. He just missed another three on my stat sheet. All right. And we're going to run it back. I'm going to run it back. It looks like he doesn't really want to play. I don't know what's going on here. But his shot selection is not the brightest. He's horrible shot selection. He's not attacking the rim because he can't. He clanks that one right there. He's not sprinting back on defense. On a game that's on NBA TV, he's not sprinting back on defense. Oh, LiAngelo misses another one. He misses a little bunny at the rim. Does he get back on D? Clamp up. Get in a stance. Go get in help now. Get in help now. Oh, man. Oh, they called a travel on the big man. I didn't think that was a travel. Is he hurt? I don't know. I don't think he's hurt. I think he's kind of lazy on the defensive end. All right, LiAngelo with the ball. Good cross. Ooh. Ugly, but it went in. You thought it was a travel? I didn't think it was a travel. I mean, I didn't replay it. If I replay it, I'll probably see it. I'm not replaying the other team's plays.
Jordan Bell to KJ, and he hits another one.
The FedEx workers knocked down another three. All right, Gelo, another deep three. What the hell is he doing? So the last three threes that he's taken, he's been at least 2 to 3 steps behind the NBA three-point line.
I would like to know how many threes KJ has made in this first half.
So right here. So, again, it's called having at least awareness. So, things like this is what I tell my players. When you drive, you don't always have to drive to score. But I want you to imagine this. So you see the guy setting the screen right here, right? So I'm going to put my mouse on it. There's a guy right here setting the screen. Now imagine the space that Gelo could create. If he rejects the screen and drives baseline, that means he's driving into a gap because they have no bigs at the rim. That means literally multiple blue players are going to have to all flash to the ball to stop him. Otherwise, he has a layup. If they come to him, that's when he can actually be a playmaker because you have three guys overloaded on the opposite side that you can pick and choose to pass to. So the best option here would be to reject. And all you have to do is look up to see these things and drive baseline. Look, you guys see right here, there's nobody under the rim. Literally, nobody under the rim. And when you settle for shots like this, this is a horrible shot.
Definitely.
That's not a good shot.
LiAngelo ball a little short. KJ again.
The FedEx airballed the three. Did I say LeBron was better than MJ? Emmanuel Scott. I have a video with my top 10 all time on it. Go watch it. If you actually go watch that, you would know that answer. I have Jordan as the GOAT, Emmanuel Scott. I seen you say that in one of my comments. You got to stop saying lies, man. I got videos out that tell you my top 10.
Short. Jordan Bell with the rebound in chapter 562.
Oh, shit. Now, I got to rewind that. I ain't see that. I don't remember that happening in game.
Marquise back down. Short. Jordan Bell with the rebound.
Oh, I don't remember that. Damn, he threw that off. Damn, that was a good-ass pass.
Jordan Bell with the hoop.
Damn. That was nice right there. I ain't gonna lie.
Street volume 2 growing up.
What is the score? God damn. What the hell is... And see, look, I'm gonna tell y'all. Now, this is what happens. On a game that's on NBA TV, right? Gelo is taking a ton of shots. I'm gonna count them up at halftime, right? But when the so-called best player on the team starts chucking and taking bad shot after bad shot, you know what everybody else starts doing? They start doing what this fool just did. Because if I'm coaching, he's coming out the game immediately after this dumbass shot. Look at this. This is a shot from a guy that's saying to himself, why do we keep passing the ball to Gelo and all he's doing is chucking up all the shots? This is a shot that says, I'm tired of passing this motherfucker the ball and he ain't making no shots. Watch. Hold on, AB the hero. He says, this is what I was telling you. The style of offense they are playing. It's a pretty carefree. It's the Drew League, AB. Ain't nobody running no offense. If you look at the other team, they ain't running no plays. They out there, but they just playing basic basketball. Pass, cut, screen away. Just the basic things you need to do to score in a basketball game. The other team ain't running nothing special. Ain't nobody. When Hezzy got dropped 40 on LiAngelo, he wasn't running no plays. This is the Drew League. Ain't nobody running plays. They don't need a certain style of offense. All you have to do is just have basic, standard basketball IQ to have success. Right? Because when I look at the talent, this big guy number 17 and number 13 on the BBB team, those two guys are not bad. Those are good players. But that shot that he just took was a frustration shot. Because you know what? I'm going to go ahead and count it up for you. One, two. LiAngelo is taking 24 shots in the first half, and we're not even done. We're not even done at halftime yet. And he's only made, he's 8 of 24 at the half. He's 8 of 24 at the half. And all of his shots are horrible shots. And so this team right here, this is a team where I've showed you guys on multiple plays where Gelo's abandoned him on defense, trying to cherry pick. And it's these guys doing all the work, trying to get rebounds, just to pass it to him. AB, I don't care. If number 13 played in the JBA, I'm just telling you from what I've seen, it looks like he can hoop. There's no need for LiAngelo to force up 24 shots when you got players like 17 and 13 on your squad. For what? There's no need for that. If you're trying to win, remember this game is on NBA, on the NBA app. This is a game being featured by the NBA. Why don't you put your best foot forward? Now would be the time to do so.
Just like that, 2 seconds left.
60-40 is the score, Sky. 60-40. Josh Jackson says, yeah, dudes jack up shots at the Drew. Dudes do jack up shots. But we not talking about other dudes. We talking about the guy that y'all said had a great game, Josh Jackson. And you said, Josh Jackson, you said this was one of his better games when he's had 33. See, you didn't expect nobody to actually go back and watch the game. You thought we was going to run with them BallisLife clips? Nah, we watching the full game. I'm sorry, Josh Jackson. My bad. Now that I'm showing the full game, now y'all want to get to talking all this other. Why? Oh, everybody else do it. Everybody, remember, what do y'all always say? Everybody else ain't LiAngelo. Everybody else don't got two brothers in the NBA. So he's 8 of 24 in the first half. All right, so 62-40 with 2 minutes to go in this half. Yeah, Celtics Lord, that's what it was. I don't think he watched the game. Ain't no way he watched the game. See? All I'm doing is just playing the full game. And now y'all, Josh Jackson just said this was a decent game. Josh Jackson. All right, we just going to get to the end score. Josh Jackson said this was a decent game. I don't know any time somebody would say they played a decent game when they got blown out by 40. How? How was it a decent game?
They can, you know, have a nice little cushion
That's what I'm saying. They losing by 22 at half. This ain't no great game. He said shooting 15 or 40 is a decent game. What? He said, I don't know. I can't get some of y'all comments. It's coming too fast on my screen. It says number 17. Dex says number 17 played at Cal State Fullerton. Made the NCAA tournament versus Duke. Oh. So is that why he looked nicer than Gelo, Dex? Is that why he looked like a better prospect than Gelo? That might explain it, Dex. Because he do. If we being honest, he do. And Dex, let's not act like Cal State Fullerton is a powerhouse. It's just Cal State Fullerton. Nice campus, though. One of the nicest campuses I've been to. I ain't going to lie. Damn, he bodied him, though. He did get dunked on, though. Is they spam? I say one thing about Bitcoin, and now I got this Bitcoin thing spamming me up, man. God damn. You said Boulevard better than Steve Nash? I can't even argue with that one. Steve Nash been a little bit of trash. Steve Nash got everybody arguing and fighting with each other. He done split up the friendship with KD and Kyrie. James Harden left town. He got rookies rebelling on things that he says in the summer league. I mean, oh, man, he gets no respect. No, hold on. Yeah, I can't say Jello's not the athlete because I can swear I was watching that Ball in the Family show or whatever it's called, and they were saying Gelo had a 42-inch vertical. So, I don't know, man. It says Bitcoin was in Showtime and but yeah, I don't know what the hell that Bitcoin thing is, man. Salute to Michael Matroki. Hopefully I'm saying that name right, man. Salute, man. Another elite mod, FYF Sports, man, all over the place. Hey, Mike, man, you gotta get me plugged in with Fresh and Fit, man. How do you become a mod over there, man? You gotta, man, we gotta get one of those guys over here, man. You gotta plug me in. He says Gelo best game in the Drew was second game. He dropped 27-12. All right. Oh, second half starts. And LiAngelo starts the second half with a miss. So he starts the second half off with another deep three miss. So we're going to throw that on there right there. No, I'm just telling you what they said. They said he had a 42-inch vertical. Maybe they was just gassing for the cameras. I don't know what it is. So second half has started. Maybe there can be some redemption here in the numbers. And LiAngelo misses another shot, another fadeaway jumper. So he's already taken two shots. Second half just started. He says, Dex, no, I'm not lying. The game, the BBB won last year. LeVar didn't coach. No, that's true. Oh, did he get an assist? Angel with another assist. One rebound, two assists, and one steal. Six turnovers for LiAngelo so far. Okay, so it looks like they pan. It looks like the defensive movement. It looks like they're trying a little bit more. Maybe it's because they got rested. But dude just knocked down the three-pointer. It was so easy. Yeah, they are 0-8. Basically, if you need a win, you want to play the BBB team. That's a free win. If you're struggling to find your jumper, play the BBB team. You're going to get right. Oh, Gelo with the jumper right there.
No bank on that one. I like it. All Jordan Bell swings it.
Play deep. You better not let him score on you. Oh, my God, man. Hold on. Oh, my God. He let Flight Sports TV knock a three down in his face. Look at this. That y'all didn't know it. That was Flight Sports TV out there. Watch this. Look at this. That is Flight. That looks like him too. Because Flight said he kind of tall. Flight Sports TV did say he was kind of tall. That's Flight Sports TV, man, pulling up on his own homeboy. Flight, man, you're supposed to fall back, man. You're not supposed to be doing all that. Watch this. Swings it. Flight whispering to him, Gelo, play up so I don't hit this shot, man. You better play D. And he still didn't play up. Camper. And Flight, you're gonna light your own man up on the NBA app. You're going to light your own homeboy up on the NBA app, on NBA.com, knowing that I was going to watch it. He banged that. He banged that. That was a good shot right there. I gotta lie.
Okay. Don't let the size fool you. He's a big guy.
Yeah, he fooled me.
But he can shoot.
I like it. And back on D, too.
Damn.
At this point, Shay, I think you would be going to knock down some threes.
All right, man. Hold on. Does this game get any better? At this point. Oh, Jello with a post.
On the other end.
Can he knock it down? He missed another odd turnaround fadeaway shot. That leads to a bucket for the other team. Another missed shot. So I think he's taken 5 shots early in this quarter already. Oh, floater right there. Now, I got to do like Dex. Because this that clip of that floater, that was one of the clips that was floating around on everybody's highlight video saying that he had a great game. So we're going to replay it. I got to mark it down too. He did hit a floater. He knocked down the floater. Yeah, he had to have been jumping off a trampoline. Oh, and he scored on the big, too. Good little floater. With the right hand. Knocks it in.
70 to 46. 6 minutes left in the third.
I'll say this, Shay. Regardless of how this game ends, Jello's going to have a nice highlight.
Hey, but Greg Helt can hoop, though. You know Greg Helt played overseas, though. Greg Helt's a baller. I played against him in real life. That man, he's bigger, but that man is nice. And he got bunnies. Yeah, I can't knock Greg Helt. I didn't play against him in real life. Hey, Kamal Abstract, I'm not really trying to expose him. Only thing I'm doing, I'm just playing the game. I'm not doing nothing special. Because even if you look to today, DKM dropped a video today saying that after LiAngelo's recent performance, he has the eye of NBA teams. That's what he said. DKM dropped a video today saying that based on this game. So I said, I got to watch this game. That's why we watching it. With a post, Gelo. Knock down the fade. Turnaround fadeaway. He knocks it down. We got to give him another bucket right there. You know what? We'll replay it for Dex. All right, turnaround fadeaway. Now, he had to get big homie back. So, Flight, it looks like Flight Sports TV is guarding him again. And he had to get Flight Sports TV back. Because dude is about the same size and everything as Flight Sports TV. And he hits the turnaround fadeaway over Flight Sports TV. Knocks, misses it. Missed the three. He says, you exposing all the overhyped the game. Yeah, they definitely did overhype this game. Because this is a trash-ass game, man. This game is trash. This BBB team is garbage. And LiAngelo is playing garbage right with him. I mean, if you're just being honest, he's playing garbage. And they back into this full court type of pressure. He about to body little homie. Another wide open three. And the FedEx workers hit another three. LiAngelo cherry picked. You better make that. How you cherry pick and miss? How you cherry pick and miss? But he did miss, though. So we got to write that down. So that's another miss. Hold on, man. God damn, bot. Okay. Oh, man. Hopefully I might have to make somebody a mod just to get them up out of here. Hold on. Let me see what's going on here. All All right, hold on. We're going to get back to it. So it's 48-75. Is that the score? All right, let me play it some more. Gelo taking off again. Don't know if the ball made or missed. He's just taking off. Shoots a quick shot. Put the ball on the floor. Just go get the layup. Tries to get the steal. Can't get it. Please don't set the bullshit press up. Please drop. Yeah, just please just drop because y'all ain't defending at all. He says, FYF, why don't IT and Trez play with the BBB team? Because Memphis 10, because they not trying to go out there and play, get embarrassed. I mean, and a lot of times they go on teams with their homeboys and whatnot.
Wasn't ready. Good pass by KJ, though.
And I don't even know if LeVar would allow that, because then they would get the bulk of the shots. LiAngelo couldn't do nothing. Okay, so LiAngelo, this is his first time going to the free throw line today. He drove, he got fouled. So he's on. This is the first time at the free throw line. For whatever reason, he's not driving to the basket. And he has no aggression, no want, nothing in him today is making him want to drive. Score is 75-48. They are getting dogged right now. 4 minutes to go in the third. He says, no hate, but who is 16? He knocks it down. I don't know. Who's 16 on what team? He says, so when Trey and Colin stink it up into Drew, it's cool. But when Gelo have a mid game, no. Josh Jackson, I don't know what blogs you not seeing, but they was destroying Montrez. They destroyed THT. They just anytime you don't perform into Drew, you get dogged. I don't know what you act like we don't read and we don't see. I be knowing when they all play trash. LiAngelo misses another three. What you mean? You be acting like it's just for Gelo. The funny thing is when Gelo plays bad, the funniest thing is that y'all run around saying he played good. When THT plays bad, he gets destroyed. All these other guys that play bad, Denzel Valentine, Montrez, John Collins, they was getting destroyed.
Knockdown shot.
So, I might be one of the only ones out here, actually, and I'm not even destroying them. I'm just replaying the game. It seemed like Josh Jackson is just more mad because I'm replaying the game. He says, Lamont, he says, Trey Young and John Collins have nothing. That's what I'm saying, too. They don't have nothing to prove. They got their contracts already. They don't. First of all, they not going to be out here running and jumping up and down so one of these fools can run up under them and end their season. Hey, little homie right here can shoot, though. Homie can shoot. Homie has like 5 threes. You better not shoot that. God damn, bro. See what I'm saying? Misses another three. I'm running out of space for the misses on my scoreboard here. I'm running out of space. Gelo hit a jumper and I missed it. All right, hold on. I thought I wrote it down. Here, I'll write it down. Just if y'all say I missed it, I'm going to write it down. I don't remember missing it, though. But I just added it just in case. 2 points won't help his percentage anyway. Not right now anyway. But either way, this is still a dumbass shot. Dumbass shot. And remember, every time he shoots these horrible threes, the paint is always wide open. And look how far back he is. Oh, I was ranting. All right, my bad. But he did miss this motherfucker.
Can't hit it.
And they going the other way.
Back down the other way.
Foul.
LiAngelo with the steal.
But a foul was called.
That's what I'm saying. I think Josh Jackson and Dex and I'm saying stuff in the chat to try to throw me off my square so I miss some of these numbers.
Going to sub out as well as KJ Fagan. Oh, and I am a
I mean, Josh Jackson, I'm just saying, these are even bad threes for a pro-am game.
Chris Camper.
These threes ain't good for any league. Like, look at the other team. The other team is not running no real offense. They just really moving the ball around. They skipping it across the court. That's just regular ball movement. That's not nothing special. They didn't have to sit down and talk about that. They just move the ball and just be normal basketball players. Kick it out. Knock down the three, homie. Oh, little dude finally got a bucket on the NBA app. I believe so, Kobe Talk Show. It's like any other program. We got a few out here.
Johnson to Chris Camper.
Man, Flight, does he hit another one? Ain't no Flight Sports TV can shoot like that.
Every single player on their team, Shay, can shoot.
Ballin'.
They letting everybody knock threes down on them. I'm not going to lie. LiAngelo with another miss.
LaCou back out to Marquise. Loses it. LiAngelo in the paint.
Team BBB runs.
No good.
No plays. Yeah, they don't. No, it's not. They don't need plays. You just want to play smart. Does he? Please don't knock it down.
Ooh, that was another one.
They must have been training with Steph all summer or something. I don't know what's going on.
Okay. Oh, lost it.
It's getting ugly, y'all.
Chapter 562 is going to bring it back down the court.
Hey, you know the prop? You know the funny thing is? I don't know how is he close to 33 points yet? I don't think he's I don't even know if the 33 points is accurate. We'll see here though.
Tavar is yelling that they need a full court press.
No, they don't need the full court press.
And that's tough to do as well, Shay, when you only got six players on the team.
Yeah.
The full
court
press. Swinging it around. Look, that's just basic ball movement.
Only a little bit left in the third quarter and a fourth quarter left, and they're down 30. So,
damn.
You gotta do something. Don't want to do that.
He better not make that.
Wide open. Didn't hit that one though.
You're lucky you missed that one. He's been knocking them down all game long.
What do y'all think about his performance so far, y'all? If y'all had to grade his, based on what y'all have seen so far, we've been watching this full game. What grade do you, what letter grade do you give him? A, B, C, D, F? What grade do you give him?
Yeah, you're right. It's getting uglier.
It's been a 3-point contest for the Chapter 562.
I appreciate that, Nicholas Brown.
Couldn't do it. But Chapter 562 with the rebound, and KJ tries again. Another one doesn't make it. Marquise for three, sinks it. Oh, and the
number 13?
Corrected me, it was a two.
He could play.
Inside the line.
You said D minus F.
Up and under. He misses that.
Cello, you got to start coming back down the court, man, on defense.
Logan for three. You might be right, Darnell. It's a 3-point contest now. Bernard Johnson.
Get down court.
Jordan Bell, another dunk.
Man.
He said F, low effort, poor shot selection. C plus, Josh Jackson with a C plus. Oh, man. D minus F, G for garbage. He said double the ball, LeVar. Stop saying that, LeVar. Literally, listen to this. You could hear LeVar saying double the ball. And they just throw a lot. This is what happens when you got guys that know how to move the ball around in a pro-am league, and you out here running gimmick defenses because it used to work when you played 14-year-olds in high school.
Jordan Bell.
LeVar needs to understand these are grown men. You know how many times they've seen presses? It's a reason why NBA teams don't press like this.
At this point, Shay, like I said a few minutes ago, the fatigue, you can clearly see it's starting to come in. Big time three, though. They're still, I'll say this.
Third quarter is over. Third quarter is over. I'm going to give you guys a point update so far. All right?
Man. Like you said, it went from ugly to uglier, but we still have another quarter left.
I've seen amazing things at the Drew, Shay. So you know,
we have seen crazier things happen.
So right now, LiAngelo is 11 of 34, and he currently has.
What do I think they have to do to cut to the lead?
Just cut into the lead. Not necessarily win the game, but cut to the lead, Shay.
My only advice, which has been my advice.
And he has 24 points.
From the beginning, it's just
so currently right now, he has 24 points.
Came into the game doing, you know what I mean?
And he's 11 of 34 from the field.
Well, especially with just
that's after three quarters.
I understand that he is. Players, but right. He can't do it himself, especially when Chapter 562 has five players on the court at any time that can kind of do it all.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, they're swinging the ball. They're
and he's 2 of 10 from the three-point line.
Everybody can't.
So 11 of 34 from the field, 2 of 10 from the three-point line at the end of the third. And they are getting destroyed.
Like I said, Chapter 562,
they're getting blown out.
Season, but it's also BBB's first season as a team.
Oh, hold on. They playing Frank Nitti and them tomorrow?
They're 0-7. Oh. It's hard to kind of come out of not winning any.
I might react to that game live. I'm going to do a live reaction. Make sure y'all pull up tomorrow. Because if that's who they play tomorrow, I'm doing that game live.
Yes, 100%, man. Like I said before, the one
Josh Jackson said, Jello going to cook Nitty?
Has been balling. I mean,
yeah. Josh, you know nobody believes that at all.
Down shot after shot. He's doing one-hand floaters, fadeaways.
I got you, Mahari. I got
he's
you.
The line. Like, he's really
I just got your other one edited, so we about to drop that one, and I did a few of my own.
Absolutely.
He says, Jello will show up and go off. Yeah, y'all been saying that. Josh, y'all said he went off this game.
Let's see what BBB in Chapter 562 does with the last 8 minutes.
Say you really on Jello meat. Bro, Frank Nitti and them about to put on a show.
Bernard Johnson swings it.
And Montrez?
We got.
Double. Go double him. That's what LeVar's saying. And he gets a layup. Jello with a three. Misses another three. That was wide open, too. That was a wide open three. I don't know. Hey, Marcus, I'm going to find out the time. And I'm going to put out the live. Once I find out what time they play, I'm going to put it on my community post. I'm going to try my best to do that game live. I will be doing that game live if I can. Damn, they are knocking down threes. Hey, this team full of FedEx workers can shoot the basketball. These are all regular average Joes. Oh, my God, man. Did he just post him up? So, LiAngelo misses another shot. The turnaround jumper on the little guy didn't work. Hey, I almost think he might have more than 40, missed 45. It might be worse than 15 or 45. It might be worse. I don't even know if he has 33 points from what I'm counting. Know. He might get it. I don't know.
Nelson back to the outside.
Go defend. That's Flight.
That.
And he airballed.
Why?
He says, are we going to act like superstars don't have bad shooting percentages? Hey, Germ, you're right. They don't have bad shooting percentages in the NBA. But when they play FedEx workers, they light them up.
No.
I'm just saying, the only reason I'm doing the stats over it's because I know y'all was a lot of people who put these fake stat lines out was lying about the stats. I seen one stat line that said he had like 8 assists. The man only has 2 assists today. 2 assists, 1 steal, and 1 rebound.
Uh-oh.
Germ says you're a hater for real. Germ, how am I hating? I'm just playing the game. Just watch the game. Oh, did he get a 3? Was that LiAngelo? Hold on. LiAngelo with a 3. Okay, so LiAngelo knocks down a 3. Okay. Well, he says Marcus says why Jello fade on every shot. Like, I don't know. But that's not a good thing. I tell you that much. It's not a good thing.
Mr. Ball.
That was a quick shot. It's just. When you think about it, how many of those shots would he get at a higher level? He's not getting those looks in Summer League or the G League. Definitely not getting them in the NBA. Oh, good shot. Good call, ref. It was definitely was a turnover.
Hey, coach. Coach, let the young man get busy, man.
He says Gelo got a quick release. Yeah, he does.
Hey, coach.
What happened there?
Backcourt foul.
Is that a turnover? Damn, that is a turnover. Fuck. Now I got to get this man another goddamn turnover. That's 7 turnovers. All right, man. Just the numbers is getting ugly. This man is almost at 10 turnovers for the game. All right, let's play it. Look, y'all, I know this is a lot of bad basketball, but this is the last quarter. It's almost over with. We are almost done watching this horrible display of basketball. Horrible display.
We're just under the 6-minute mark. 104-70. Young fabulous. Oh, inside.
Okay, Gelo. Was that a rebound? Hold on. Make sure I don't miss nothing. Hold on. I could see. I missed it. It was going too fast. I was looking at something else. Just need to make sure it wasn't a rebound. No, it's
inside and partially blocked. Here comes ball.
Just grabbed a loose ball. Ball with the assist. Nope, didn't get the assist.
Reed, yes. Nice finish by Mr. Reed.
They still pressing for some reason. Why are you still pressing? The press ain't been working. Bro, they put an even bigger dude in to guard LiAngelo.
Get that out of here.
They put the biggest dude they got on their roster on LiAngelo.
Yes.
I would be shitty. That would be disrespectful. That's disrespectful. Oh, my God. Out there looking like Flight reacts playing defense. And he took off already. Y'all see Gelo take off quick than the mug, trying to get down court? You better score. Missed another three. Horrible shot. And he should have drove. He had a wide open. Oh, man.
Now you gotta go get a haircut.
He says he's literally playing by himself. No, he's not playing by himself. His team is... Look, little homie right there been hooping. Number 17 been hooping. LiAngelo been playing like hot garbage. If you really look at the numbers, LiAngelo's one of the primary reasons why they getting blasted by 40. Uh-oh, make one, please. Missed another three. Damn.
Young Fab, pull up in the middle, though. Rebound, kick out, stolen. Wait a minute.
Gelo, come back and play defense. Come back, Gelo.
No.
Come back, Gelo.
Rebound.
Gelo, come back. Gelo ain't back yet. What the fuck does Gelo be doing? What the fuck is Gelo doing, man? Did somebody forget to tell Gelo this game is on NBA.com, app on NBA.com, where millions of people are watching this? The man is out of the camera frame. God damn. Y'all talk about cherry picking to the extreme? God damn. Look at this.
No.
Oh, I'm going to go all the way back to when he... Look. Gelo ain't back. Watch how long he stays in the backcourt. He still ain't back.
No.
They got the rebound. Gelo still ain't back. Ball still in play. Gelo still ain't back. Shot goes up. Gelo still ain't back. They still got the ball. Gelo still ain't back. Gelo comes to the half court line. Oh, he came back. He came back. Damn, but by the time he came back, they done smacked a three. Oh, man.
Inside Luka Noah.
Oh, he almost disrespected him with that one. Gelo with a rebound. I saw the rebound, Gelo. And the assist.
Yes.
Gelo with the rebound and the assist on that one play.
He's
This is a clown show, man. This is a joke of a game, bro. This the last game of the day at LA Fitness. This how the last game of the day at LA Fitness look when everybody tired. And don't nobody want to keep playing. Foul. Why would LeVar call the timeout? LeVar wait to the fourth quarter when he getting blasted by 40 to call a timeout. LeVar ain't called a timeout this whole time. They getting blasted by 40. LeVar called a timeout. What the fuck do you think LeVar is saying to him with the timeout? Look. It's 116-80. He called his first timeout of the game when you getting blasted. What do y'all think he said? Ain't nothing you can say. They probably all about ready to cuss him out right now. Man, come on, man. That's crazy in the mud, man. What, I don't know what's going on here. Damn. I don't know what he's saying to him. Maybe he cussing Gelo out for not getting back. Hey, whoever little homie is, little dude right there can hoop though. Whoever he is, he needs to be. If you move that point guard for the BBB team, this guy number 13. If you put him on a legitimate Drew League team, he could get buckets. He can hoop. Whoever he is, he could play. Now he's definitely not gonna make it in the NBA. Yeah, Sky, yeah, he's probably saying let's pass to Gelo so he can stat pad for the rest of the game. We got to figure something out, man. I can't all stars next. Don't go nowhere. All right, they still pressing. They still pressing. 2 minutes left to... Oh, the steal. Ah, no, they don't get the steal. Gelo, better get back in defense. Get in the frame. Get in the frame, Gelo. Get in the frame, Gelo. Gelo, get back in the frame. Where you going, Gelo? Oh, okay. He cherry picked. Oh, does he get the assist? No assist there. Little guy say, not today, big fella, not today. He says, we getting cooked, but pass the ball to Gelo. I don't know what they saying, man. Look, y'all. All I'm doing, for again, if you're just coming in, all I'm doing is we just replaying the game. As hard as it is to watch, because there's a lot of people. I told y'all, DKM just dropped a video. I'm going to tell you exactly what his title was. DKM said, this is what DKM said after watching this game. He made a video entitled it, LiAngelo Ball Noticed by NBA After Scoring Performance in Televised Drew League Game. That's what, he did that title today. Like, he literally had time to sit down and think about that title. Oh, he missed another three. He had time to watch the game. He had time to really reconsider this. And he dropped a video today and said, LiAngelo Ball noticed by NBA after scoring performance in Televised Drew. He don't even want to be on TV. He's out the frame half the time.
Check the 5-6-2 with an impressive performance. It's 117-81 right now.
That's crazy, man. Salute to DKM, though, man. Gelo, score! Step pattern. Oh, he does get a layup in.
They're still at least playing it out to the end of the game, you know what I mean?
Yes, of course, 100%.
So Gelo got a bucket at the end of the game.
It's one of them losses you can learn from.
He says, I feel bad for him because Gelo ain't a bad player. I swear, he's not a bad player in the YMCA, but he's a bad player when you put him on the court with other people that know how to hoop. All right, so the game is over, yo. All right, so hold on. So there's the score right there. 117-83. They got blasted. That is the final score. Now, we about to give you the final stats, right? So here, I'm going to pull up the stat line that everybody else was saying. So we're going to compare because, look, I literally just played the whole game. I have all the stats. Every time he scored, whatever he did, I wrote it down. And I even gave 2 extra points when somebody said I missed a jumper. So my stats should match up to everybody else's stat line, right? So I'm gonna first I'm gonna tell you what they said his stat line was. Hold on. Okay. So they said his stat line was 33 points, 4 rebounds, and 6 assists. So this was reported by Ball Facts. This was reported by DKM. I mean, these are pretty credible YouTubers, okay? That's the stat line that they reported. 33 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists. That was the stat line, okay? So let's go ahead and count them up. So we're going to count up. I'm going to give you the field goal percentage first. So let's count it up. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Forty-one shots. So he took 41 shots total. He made 13 shots. So he was 13 of 41 on the night. That was his true field goal percentage. 13 of 41 on the night. He did make 2 free throws. And I'll give you the point total. 31 points. So with the 2 free throws, he has 31 points. That's the official. 31 points on 13 of 41 shooting. The official rebound tally, we just watched the game. He has 2 rebounds. He has 3 assists. And he has 8 turnovers on this game with 0 blocks. Now, the reported stat line was 33, 4, and 6. The true stat line after watching the full game, 31 points, 2 rebounds, 3 assists, 1 steal, mind you, 8 turnovers, and 0 blocks. And let me tell you the 3-point field goal percentage, because he is a, remember, I think they call him the sniper. So let's see what his 3-point field goal percentage was. So he actually, somebody said that he made 4 threes. He actually only made 3 threes. So he only made 3 threes. But he shot. And he shot 17 threes. So it was reported. Somebody said 4 of 18 from the 3. He actually was 3 of 17 from the 3-point line. So there's a correction there. So 3 of 17 from the 3-point line. 13 of 41 from the field. Those are the stats. All right, so let me do the percentages. So let's do the percentages. We'll see. Let me pull up right here. Okay, so he shot 17% from the 3-point line. And he shot 31% from the field against the FedEx squad. Against the FedEx All-Stars with 8 turnovers. Like I said before, I don't know what y'all want me to say other than what actually happened. Now, we all sat here, and if you guys had a pen and paper too, you guys could have sat down and took the stats right with me. Matter of fact, this video is very rewatchable. You can go back and rewatch the whole game, and you can take note of the stats yourself. But see, we now know that after looking at this past game, it's a lot of people out here willing to finesse numbers any which way they can to make it look like he's playing better than what's actually happening. This is why there's so much pushback when I sometimes when I appear on certain panels and I say, well, man, when I watched the game, it didn't look all peaches and cream like y'all saying. That shit was crazy. Oh, Sway, you said that was Flight out there? I don't know what it was, but something was going on. I'm telling you. Now, it could these numbers are more reminiscent of Flight Reacts. But, I mean, for a guy that's labeled to be a sniper against the FedEx team, he shot 3 of 17. And remember, for the people that are the fair weather Charlotte Hornets fans, because we know that they're fair weather because they're only cheering for the Charlotte Hornets because LaMelo was there. So for all the fair weather Charlotte Hornets fans, why do you want to add this type of player to all of the confusion that you already got going on? You don't have a backup point guard. You don't have a true starting center. You don't have a true backup center. You don't know what the hell you're going to do at the power forward position because both the power forwards that you had, both these motherfuckers in legal trouble. You don't know where you want to use Book Knight, if he's a shooting guard, if he's a point guard. So you really don't have a true shooting guard backup. Kelly Oubre is more in the fashion than he is in the basketball. So his game has been significantly declined since he started being an Instagram model. Paris Kinsey. So his total points on the night, 31 points, 2 rebounds, 3 assists, 1 steal, and 8 turnovers. That was his true stat line. And we just documented it. We just watched the full game. And he shot 3 of 17 from the 3-point line and 13 of 41 from the field against a group of guys that all work at FedEx together. They did have Jordan Bell, though. Maybe Jordan Bell is just that nice, and he got them FedEx workers. But you know what? But if you think about it, Dex was just in here. Dex said that number 17 was the starting center at Cal State Fullerton, a D1 player. He said the point guard played in the JBA was pretty good. And then you had LiAngelo, who a lot of the Ball family fans say is NBA ready to go. That's enough to win this game. How the hell did they get blown out 117 to 83?
I don't know. Don't know what y'all want. Don't know what y'all want me to say. Oh, let me get this.
He says the Bulls should give him a shot. Why? Why would the Bulls give him a shot? And the Bulls are guard loaded as it is. The Bulls are loaded with plenty of guards. Why do they need him? They don't even know what they want to do with Kobe White. Yeah, Lonzo Ball, Kobe White, just signed Dragic. Caruso. Yeah, they don't need guards. Why do they need a 6'5 guard that can't defend? Why did they need a 6'5 guard that had a 121.9 defensive rating in the G League? Worst in the G League last year. Look, I support him too. But look, just because I support him don't mean I gotta lie to him. This game was on the NBA app. This game was not recorded by some fan on a cell phone. This game was put on the NBA app, and it's going to be on the NBA app on NBA.com forever for people to watch. This is not very hard to get the footage. And when I look at videos, like this, LiAngelo Ball scores 33 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists. Then when you look at another video that's titled
Here it is right here. You got another video that's titled LiAngelo Ball Noticed by NBA. I want y'all to listen to this. This was a video that just was published today. Now, would y'all, after watching this game, would y'all say that whoever made this video is a complete cap? LiAngelo Ball noticed by NBA after scoring performance in televised Drew League game. LiAngelo Ball needs to be getting an attorney to get some type of temporary injunction to get this game removed from the NBA.com. That's what he needs to be doing. He needs to be saying, y'all, I didn't give y'all permission to use my likeness. And we got to get this taken down. That's what he needs to be doing. Exactly, Scotty. Gave him points. So, again, I don't know what to tell y'all. I mean, maybe he comes out and plays better. But see, here's the problem that this entire summer, him playing bad has been consistent. Now, has he been able to, I think this entire summer league included, he may have, I think he's played two games that I would consider slightly above average. That's the 27-point performance earlier in the Drew League, and then the 12-point performance in 12 minutes in the summer league. Which, again, in the summer league, that 12-point performance was marred by the fact that he had four fouls in 12 minutes as well. So he was on his way to fouling out. And then that was further marred by the fact that Brady Manek also, in that same game, had 12 points in 12 minutes. He just also had rebounds, assists, and steals to go with it, unlike Gelo. Like, you can't come to me and be like, oh, 12 points in 12 minutes is impressive. And then a guy named Brady Manek, looking like he just been plowing corn all day, also did the same thing. But ain't nobody running around here on a YouTube video parade trying to make videos for Brady Manek saying he's next up in the NBA because he scored 12 points in 12 minutes. He says Gelo only got consistent minutes in the Drew League because his dad was the coach, Josh Jackson. Just say that. That's why. Gelo played the entire game because LeVar's coaching the team. When you put LiAngelo on teams that LeVar isn't coaching, like when he was at UCLA, he doesn't start. Like when he was in Lithuania, he didn't start. And he might have started a few games. But for the most part, he was a guy that they were bringing off the bench. I want y'all to tell me. When he was in the JBA up under LeVar, he played the entire game. I want y'all to tell me, whenever he's played in a situation that hasn't been dictated by LeVar, the coaches don't start him. He can't control the swarm. He can't control the Greensboro swarm. Gelo don't play or start. It has to be some connection there. And we can't keep running around saying the man's blackballed. Because if he was blackballed, then they would just not associate him with the NBA at all. Well, yeah, I know the JBA talent was trash. I saw a JBA game and the score was like 178 to 160. That's trash. That's not basketball. Facts, guy. Any other coach is benching you. I know I am. And I'm not even a coach. I'm not even the type of coach to yank kids or pull them because they miss shots. The only time I really start to yank and kids out the game, because you can't control making and missing shots for the most part, but you can control effort and how you make up for mistakes. Are you hustling back on D? Are you defending with energy? Are you talking on defense? Right? Are you finding other ways to have an impact on the offensive side of the floor? Right? Let's just say LiAngelo woke up and just had an off night offensively. There were still other ways he could have impacted this game other than hoisting up more and more shots, which led to this embarrassing performance, 117 to 83. Yeah, the JBA was not serious. I don't consider the JBA. Now, the format of the JBA, I did appreciate the format of the JBA. The format and the purpose was beautiful.
giving guys an opportunity to play without being forced to go to college is similar to what, because the NBA ultimately stole LeVar Ball's idea of the JBA. And then that's when they created the G League Ignite team, which is essentially the JBA. That's exactly what the G League Ignite team is. It's basically the JBA, just better coaching, better players, better compensation for the players. That's all it is. And they were only able to do it better because they just had an extensive network of resources where they could actually go recruit kids and go sign them to contracts and money. And you wouldn't have a whole bunch of guys running around saying they didn't get paid. But if you're being honest, the NBA stole the JBA concept from LeVar Ball. That is factual. That's what I'm saying. As a businessman, as a marketer, LeVar Ball is unmatched. But when you come to actual basketball and coaching, LeVar Ball is hot garbage. So. Final stats, man. We're going to run them down once. He says, I think Gelo nice. You know what? Hey, look, y'all. Y'all honestly, if you want, I think Gelo should just simply go the route that like the Frank Nitties and some of the content creators are going. Because he has such a huge following on social media where a lot of these kids look up to him, love to play with him alongside of him. I mean, he's nicer than most just average Joes walking around. I think he should just hit the IRL circuit with some of these YouTubers and just as our goal, create a YouTube channel and just start being a content creator, making content. If he started a YouTube channel and start putting out IRL content, he would start getting millions of views just like that. Let's say he partnered up with some of these other guys and created a team. Guys who might be really talented, but just not good enough to get into the NBA. But you can take over the IRL circuit and go crazy. There's no disrespect for him. But you have to understand that the NBA is not for everybody. And your opportunity, the window of opportunity that you have to get into the NBA is extremely small. You don't have, if you don't get drafted, you don't have a window of 10 years to get into the league. You don't have that type of time. If teams haven't signed them to a two-way contract yet, that should tell you something. When you look at all of the young players that just entered the NBA this year, Scottie Pippen Jr., what's the big guy name that just got signed with Memphis? He came out of Louisiana Tech. These guys got two-way contracts already. And they haven't played one G League or NBA game. Gelo's been a free agent since 2018. And he hasn't got a sniff of a real contract. Not even a two-way deal. It's not hate, but sometimes if this information actually reaches LiAngelo in some way, shape, or form, yeah, that's his name, Lofton Jr., it's time to reevaluate your game plan. And I think LiAngelo has actually told people what his game plan was, and some of the extreme Ball family fans refuse to hear what he's saying. LiAngelo has publicly come out and said he likes what he's doing. He said he likes being in Charlotte, being close to his brother who's in the NBA. He said he loves being able, you know, to go hoop with him and be close to him. The things that are coming out of LiAngelo's mouth don't sound like a guy who's really fighting for a spot on some random NBA team. It sounds like a guy who's living comfortably, playing in the G League, and he's happy with being close to his brother, Lamelo, in Charlotte. And then, I obviously, with the free time that he has, he can also be close with Zoe. They all have some form of NBA affiliation. And you know, is it impossible that he gets a 10-day contract? No. I can see towards the end of a season. You know, I can see towards the end of the season, if the season's lost and there's nothing really to gain by playing, by pushing for more wins, I can see them giving him a quick 10-day contract just to kind of show LaMelo a little bit of respect and appreciation. Maybe the fans can see for one time those two on the court. Maybe we can see the the assist from LaMelo to LiAngelo in an actual NBA game. But as far as an actual contract really getting caught up, having a true opportunity over some of these other guys that are really out here grinding, when we look at guys like LJ Figueroa, who from last year to this year, there was an visible improvement that you can see from the way he physically looked to his game. When you look at, you know, when you look at a guy named Bryce McGowan's, he came in looking like, damn, we fine tune a few things here or there. He is fit for this NBA roster. He says Melo's spirit on the court compared to Gelo's is exactly, and it's called body language. Gelo's body language is horrible, y'all. He puts his head down every time he misses a shot. He gives up on plays far too often. He gives no effort on the defensive side of the ball. This is not me talking. We just played a full game and watched a full game. All of these things were true. He takes horrible shots and has horrible shot selection. He had not confident in his handle and will not drive unless you force him to drive. And then even when you force him to drive, he's not looking to play make or really create anything of relevance out of it. Once he puts his head down and drive, he has something that we call tunnel vision. That means he's only looking at the rim. That's the only thing he can see. And he's not about to play make to save his life. Thus, why he only had 2 assists today. So, it is what it is, man. You know, we're going to go ahead and wrap it up. The game is over. BBB team lost 117-83. I'm going to do my best if I'm able to get access, and I should be able to. I got to check with NBA playmakers to see if they'll give me a link to where I can stream the game tomorrow without getting copyrighted. But I will do my best to do the live reaction to the game tomorrow while the game is being played. Because again, then we can't get finessed, because just looking at the stats from today, we clearly see that people are willing to go out there and finesse, say, or do anything just to make him look better than what he's actually doing on the court. The one thing that they know, or the one thing that they're counting on, is a lot of people are counting on the fact that they're banking on no one actually going back and doing any real research. Right? Sometimes a lot of people just want you to tune in and be like, this is what happened, except what I say as fact. And I just, again, that's just not something I can do. If LiAngelo comes out tomorrow and plays a great game, I see renewed defensive effort and intensity, right? If they get out of this bogus full court press that don't work. Look, y'all, they play Frank Nitti and the Montrezl Harrell tomorrow. Do y'all think they're going to full court press a Frank Nitti and a Montrezl Harrell? Do y'all think they're going to – okay, go ahead and press Frank Nitti and Montrezl Harrell tomorrow. And you thought getting beat 117-83 was bad. Go ahead. I want to see them press Frank Nitti tomorrow. I really want to see it. I really want to see that. Yeah, we should have had way more than 100 likes. Hold on, maybe I had that number wrong. We should have way more than 158 likes. All right, if I see some of you guys watching on Twitch, some of you guys watching on some of these other platforms, make sure y'all come over to YouTube and hit the like. This should easily be at least 300 likes already, if not more. He says, why do you think they're upselling them? Just fandom. It's the same thing with any other player. Just being extreme fans of a player. For me, though, Nico, it's disrespectful because I see a lot of other guys who don't have a million-dollar engine in the big baller brand behind them, pushing them. They don't have a 2.9 million social media following. And they just have to try to get it out the mud and hope that an opportunity comes their way. This is why I got to go out there. This is why when I see Kenny Lofton Jr., when I see him play, I see a guy that's desperately trying to get into the NBA. I see a guy where even though he is a bit overweight. But coming from Louisiana Tech to the Summer League, that man slimmed down at least by 30 pounds. So I see he's been putting in work on his body, his game. He was out there focused, and he wasn't out there crying about whatever minutes he got. He was making the most, and there's a lot of guys. Look at Travion Williams. He played for the Celtics Summer League team. What only averaged like 13 minutes a game in Summer League. But with them 13 minutes, he was showcasing great footwork, great passing. And now he just got signed by the Golden State Warriors as an undrafted player from Purdue University. But he ain't, some of these guys ain't even crying about their minutes. They taking a little 12 minutes a game and they putting in work in 12 minutes and they saying, that's all I need. So again, this league is unforgiving. It don't work like that. You get 12 minutes a game, you better maximize the shit out of them 12 minutes. Josh Jackson says he needs to play with better players, period. No. I thought his players, the talent-wise, there was no big difference talent-wise in today's game. It wasn't. Did y'all see some of the guys making some of these threes? That other team had two guys that looked like they was 250 plus. Y'all couldn't name any of the players on the other team other than Jordan Bell. Y'all didn't know none of them. How come all these other Drew League teams ain't running around talking about we need better players? How come it's just LiAngelo needs better players? Why does he specifically need better players? Jordan Bell took a whole bunch of guys that work at FedEx and they just blew them out. If y'all say LiAngelo Ball is an NBA talent, he, as the lone NBA talent on that roster, should be good enough to galvanize the rest of the guys, and they should be blowing people out by 40s, right? If you are true, and Jordan Bell is a fringe NBA guy. He's barely touching the court. Why does he need all this help in the Drew? The construction of their team is not trash. That team is fine. If you don't tell them to press the full game, if you stop telling them to go double team where they don't have to double team, if you tell them to move the ball around instead of having LiAngelo shoot 41 times, maybe they won't be trash. If LiAngelo shoots 25 times and they actually move the ball, they're probably in the game. If LiAngelo Ball is not pressing and doesn't have 8 turnovers, they could potentially be in the game. These numbers is trash. What is looking like is looking like this team just needs to get rid of Gelo and they'll get better. That's what it's looking like. Everybody keeps pointing to everybody else as the problem. Gelo is the problem on this team. 13 of 41, 3 of 17 from the three-point line with 8 turnovers. While on multiple plays, I showed y'all all 4 of them guys hustling, fighting, getting blocks, second chance, rebound, all this. And what is Gelo doing? He's parking on the other side of the court, hoping after these guys are working their ass off defensively that once they get the rebound, they chuck it up to him and he gets the layup. I just played the game. If I'm lying, I want somebody to dare say I'm lying after I just played the full game. Literally just played the full game. So now can't nobody lie and try to blame the other team. Because they went on a run. Remember when they went on that run to start the second half? When the others got those 2 stops, 2 steals, and they were on a 4-point run? That's something you could capitalize on. But then what happens? Here comes Gelo. Proceeds to chuck up the next 5 shots and not make 1 to start the half. After they went on just a little small run. But yet, y'all want to say he needs better teammates. I say they just need to get rid of Gelo. I say you get rid of the guy that's shooting it every goddamn time he touches it. He says, hold on, Josh Jackson. They were getting beat. They were getting blown out. They've especially gotten blown out the last two games they played. They have been getting beat, but they're getting beat because their whole strategy revolves around once Gelo touches the ball, he shoots it. This is not the first game that Gelo's took an absurd number of shots, Josh Jackson. In that first game, he took a ridiculous number of shots. In the second game, he took a ridiculous number of shots. In every game, he's shooting a high volume of shots just to get to a point total that's really not impacting the game whatsoever. And I can no longer trust the rebounds, assists, and steal numbers that people are putting out there because as we just did in this game, it's all cap. And truly, he had two assists today, but only one of those assists was really memorable, and that was the pass to the big man who was flying in for the dunk. I mean, people can try to lie and try to finesse all they want. This is not shade or hate towards anybody. But like I said, this is FYF. Did y'all not know what FYF means? It means fuck your feelings. I don't have time to run around here catering to people's feelings. I just got to say it like it is. And if you dare to even try to rebuttal me, then you're really going to be in a world of hurt because all I'm going to do is I'm going to come back with more facts and more videos like this just to disprove you. Y'all need to know that there's a reason why nobody's publicly came out and challenged anything that we have said, especially when it's in a video like this. And really called us out for the head-to-head, the conversation or debate. Ain't nobody done it. He says, Gelo only played, I know. And you know what? Travion Williams for the Celtics only played 12 minutes a game for the Celtics. And he got signed by the Warriors. And the only reason the Celtics couldn't sign him, even because they wanted to, they just didn't have the rosters. They had to make a tough choice between another guy. But as soon as the Celtics said, we can't sign you, Travion, you know who picked him up? The Warriors went and picked him up. See, that's what happens when you show out in summer league. If the team that you're playing on, if for whatever reason they don't have a roster space to sign you, another team's going to scoop you up quick. Why do you think the Warriors hurried up and signed Mac McClung as soon as the summer league was over? Why do you think Mac McClung got an opportunity with another team as soon as the Lakers let him go? Why do you think LJ Figueroa, who was in the Warriors organization last year, was able to get a second shot with the Charlotte Hornets this year and has a real, real opportunity to get the two-way contract? See, that's what happens when you actually hoop. It don't matter if it's 12 minutes. It don't matter if it's 20 minutes. If you a hooper, you can show it in small stints. It's so many other players in the summer league that play similar minutes and was able to showcase what they can do without crying and complaining for more minutes. Josh Jackson, Gelo did not ball out in the summer league last year. Gelo had one good game in summer league, and you guys act as if he played like that for the entire summer league. He did not. He ended summer league on a horrible note. You guys see how he tailed off. After that first game, when he exploded onto the scene, I think he had a good game the second game as well. But after that, everything declined. But you guys, like I've said, he started off the summer league last year playing pretty good. But since then, he ended pretty bad. He picked up in summer league this year bad. He had a horrible season in the G League. And now he's having a horrible outing in the Drew League, but there's a lot of people trying to give the impression that something else is going on in the Drew League that we miss. Like we the crazy ones when we say he's not playing like an NBA player. They call us crazy. We just watched the game. Josh Jackson, I can pull it up on the screen, Josh Jackson. So tell me when LiAngelo averaged 37% from the three-point line. Tell me what league to go look it up, and I will pull it up right now. I'm gonna wait, Josh Jackson. Here, I will pull it up. Tell me. Don't tell me if it was the G League. It wasn't the G League. What league? Was it the JBA? What league? I want you to tell me. Because it's definitely not in the Drew League. So, again, look, I can minimize this right here. I can pull the stats up and put them on the screen right now. No, you know, we're not going to give you time to fact check so you can correct. Remember, we're going to hold you to what you said. Y'all heard what he said, right? Y'all heard what he said. Hold on, let me put it up on the screen. He said, Josh Jackson said 37% from the three-point line, correct? So we about to look it up. Boom. Okay. So, now slap. Y'all all heard him say that. So we gonna go, so remember, where he most recently played, He LiAngelo Ball, G League stats. Okay, we're going to go to LiAngelo Ball's G League stats. Right here on Basketball Reference. I'm about to click it. He has no time to backtrack off of his statement. Okay, now we have his G League stats right here. All right, hold on. We're going to go regular season because I don't want to just count the showcase. We're going to go regular season. Hold on. Do I need this? Let me zoom in for the people that make. We're going to zoom in so nobody says it's getting finessed. Okay. LiAngelo Ball played, averaged 13 minutes a game. Now, he said he shot 37% from the three. Remember, that's what Josh Jackson said. You said 37% from the three. Now, you said I'm going outsiders right here. So, right here, what did he shoot? He shot 35% from the three-point line. That's what he shot. And he shot 39% from the field. 39% from the field is already bad. And 35% from the three-point line is average for a guy that you guys label as a sniper. No, 36 and 37 are not the same thing. Because in the NBA, once you start getting up to 37 and 38%, these are the elite guys. No. So I could just say anything's the same as 35. Well, Josh Jackson, you said he shot 37%. What stopped you from saying 40? Why didn't you say 40? Or what's wrong with just saying what he did was 35% on 4 points a game? He says the official G League site says he averaged 36.1. We got it right here. We got it right here in our face. See, what y'all keep, I'm not going on no wild goose hunt to 35 different websites till we find a number that suits you. Basketball Reference, for the most part, is extremely accurate. I'm not about to go here and chase these other websites because you think you found another number on another website, man. We see the number right here on the screen, man. It's 35%. Hey, when y'all talking about Gordon Hayward, I don't hear y'all rounding no numbers up. When y'all talking about Gordon Hayward, y'all just be saying he trash and he ain't no good. Ain't nobody rounding no numbers up for Gordon Hayward. He doesn't shoot twos. So the reason why his field goal percentage is so low in the G League, right? His field goal percentage is so low because all the shots he takes are threes. He can't take any other shot but threes because he doesn't have the speed to do it at the when you're playing guys with NBA speed. So he says he averaged 1.7 shots per game. He averaged making 1.7 field goals per game. He shot 4.3 field goals per game. When you look at his three-point attempts, he made 1.1 threes per game, but he shot three. The majority of his shots were all threes. He's out there chucking threes up. He rarely took twos. But see, but beyond, you say his 2-point field goal percentage was 48%. Ain't nobody in the NBA calling Gelo up because he can make 2-point shots. If Gelo ever gets a shot in the NBA, it's because he can shoot threes and possibly add a little bit of defense to his game. We all know this. Ain't no team in the league saying, I really love the way Gelo drives to the basket. Let's get him on the roster. He can't drive. We just saw him today throw up the worst hook shot in NBA history. Right? Even if you go to twos today, if I count his field goal percentage today against the FedEx guys, it's still just as bad as his 3-point percentage. Now he didn't get consistent minutes. You're not supposed to give consistent minutes to a player who only shoots threes and has 121.9 defensive rating. And if y'all think I'm lying about the defensive rating, I can pull that up for you. Hold on. Well, let me pull up his advanced stats. It's actually worse. It's right here in your face. It's right here in your face. It's not even 121. His defensive rating is 123. Do you know how bad of a defender you are if your defensive rating is 123 in 28 games? That's why he couldn't play no goddamn minutes. As soon as he touched the floor, he was getting cooked. And his offensive rating is not high enough for me to keep you out there. So, again, with some guys, when you look at players like the AIs, was AI a stellar defender? You can look at a lot of players like this, even if you go to Jamal Crawford's or even Lou Williams type players. These guys are horrible, atrocious defensively, but they can make up for it with elite level offense. Gelo can't do that. The numbers is right here in y'all face. I said his defensive rater was better than what it actually was. This man has negative win shares. .123 defensive rating. Now the Greensboro team is trash. See, there y'all go once again trying to blame the team for him being trash individually. Don't be trying to blame the team and don't try to blame the team when it suits the argument. We talking about him as the individual. Yeah, see, whenever things go wrong for LiAngelo, people want to say team. See, but when LiAngelo eventually has a good game, if he ever has another good game, none of the team gets credit. It's all him doing it by himself. LiAngelo plays a good game, he carried the team. But if LiAngelo plays bad, it's because the team was bad. All I'm saying is, let's not get to blaming the team. If you want to leave blaming the team to me, because I'm going to call it down the middle. But let's not leave the team blaming to people who only give credit to LiAngelo. When LiAngelo plays good, the team was still bad. He was just out there carrying the team. But when LiAngelo plays bad, well, he played bad, but it was because his teammates are bad. No, it's starting to sound like he is trash. He was on the roster for a Drew League team that got drubbed by 40. And then the week before that, they got drubbed by like 25 or 30 or something like that. He's just as much a part of the trash as they are. Don't try to separate garbage and be like, this garbage smell better than that piece of garbage. If Josh Jackson is you go to that feminine hygiene box in women's bathrooms, it's all trash. The shit all stink. You ain't pulling out each piece one at a time. This one smell better than that one. No, the whole thing is contributing to it, to all of it stinking and smelling like trash. It's all trash right now. And if it's, and you know what? If they actually win a game and he plays well, it's the same reason. It's because they all, as a unit, as a team, help contribute to it. And you want to equally disperse the credit for that as opposed to just giving it to one person. Y'all be thirsty for him to have a good game. They could very well win tomorrow and he have a good game. But y'all will never give the other guys any credit. It will be just send Gelo to the league. Oh, Gelo's ready to go. All the other guys in this Drew League that could be getting appreciation, putting in work, all this. I haven't heard none of y'all talk about any of the other Drew League players of the week. Did none of y'all talk about Chris Allen when Chris Allen was walking LiAngelo them down, taking them to the cup every time, who was also player of the game, and I think he might have been player of the week. Did nobody give him credit? Y'all gotta stop, man. Some guy who works at FedEx was but player of the game. I think his name was KJ Fagan. The guy that was making all the threes. He was player of the game this game. It wasn't even Jordan Bell. Cause so Jordan Bell, if somebody was talking about this game, there'd be a lot of people that might give Jordan Bell the credit. But when you actually watch the game, it's a lot of people out there who stuck to their roles, made open shots, and did what they're supposed to do that had a big impact on them blowing this BBB team out. So I'll be back tomorrow. We will do the game live. We will do this game live tomorrow. If I get permission to do so, I will be doing it live. So make sure you guys sub up. Hit the notification bell because you're not going to want to miss it if I go live and we're talking about for the big BBB team versus Frank Nitti and Montrezl Harrell. I'll be taking bets as well. So if anyone wants to bet on the Big Baller Brand team, I will be taking bets. And I'll also do an over-under on how many points LiAngelo Ball scores. I'll take bets on that as well. We will be doing that. Because one thing I know for certain is Frank Nitti is going to have something. Frank Nitti loves to take opportunities. He loves to take opportunity to destroy people that get out here getting more credit than they deserve. So it's probably not a good time for LiAngelo to walk in out of shape against Frank Nitti. But we'll have to see, man. We will have to see. But, man, look, y'all, I appreciate y'all. Look, it was a fun live, man. I love watching these games like this, man, having you guys react to it with me. You know what, you guys? I'm going to even give you guys the opportunity to criticize me and my coaching style because I think I'm going to do it Sunday. But Sunday, I'll be doing a live reaction to our national championship game when we play Wisconsin this year back in April in the national championship game, GCU versus Wisconsin. And we ended up losing that game. Very close game. It was a neck and neck game. Back and forth. We were up. They took the lead. We got up late. They took the game back, and then we ended up, you know, making some mistakes in the end, and Wisconsin stole the national championship trophy from us at the end. So, look, I'm going to give you guys an opportunity to get on me. There were a lot of things that when I go back and watch the game where I screwed up as a coach. See, I'm giving you guys the opportunity. Y'all can get on me. Now y'all can get on me. So it's not always about getting on Gelo, man. Now y'all can take y'all shots at my coaching style. That's what we're going to be doing. I'm going to make sure I get that. We're going to do that this weekend. So I got a lot of stuff going on. So I will try to go live more. But like I said, it's just hard to go live with so little incentive to do so. Because it just really doesn't. It's not an effective way to grow your channel. And I just wasn't getting enough back in return with regards to engagement, views, likes. Growth that, you know, when I was going live so much. So I continue with the uploads. Make sure y'all sub up to our second channel, because I'm be going live over there a lot more. But man, we got a lot of stuff to cover on this channel. He says Gelo will make it to the NBA, one or two or three. He will. And that, unfortunately, it just don't work like that, Beyond. It just don't work like that. You have a very small window if you don't get drafted. Very small window. And that window only gets smaller as you get older. It's very rare that you see 25 and 26-year-olds still be getting into the NBA as rookies. Very rare. Not saying it can't happen, but it is rare. And you have to be an elite talent to make it happen. But it's FYF Sports, man. It's been a great, great reaction video, man. I'm glad you guys came in today. Numbers were pretty good. I think we got up to over 500 people in the chat today. Engagement's crazy. Another historic month in the views. I think we've already hit 10 million views total for the channel since we've been doing this the last 2.5 years. I mean, that's ridiculous in and of itself. Just this year alone, since January, we have about 4 million views. I mean, so, man, these numbers, man, you guys, man, I appreciate you guys showing your appreciation, man, liking the videos, sharing, giving me all the engagement that's it's really been helping this channel grow. And I really expect that if we continue to grow at this rate, I can see us hitting 100K subscribers in no time. It's definitely a very real possibility by December. So, again, this channel doesn't work without you guys pulling up, giving the engagement, man. We try to keep it clean. You know, I try not to take too many personal shots at people. We do joke around sometimes. But as you can hear, I try to keep the cussing and all that to a limited, you know, basis. I don't really like to attack people on a personal level too much. We just have fun. We talk basketball. We talk hoops. Whatever is out there to talk about. And then we go about our day. You know, coming here to these channels is supposed to be a way. I look at it as a way to kind of get away. Be a stress relief. Get a few laughs. But other than that, it should not be something that makes people come to YouTube and be stressing, beefing with other people. It's all love and respect here at FYF Sports, man. But again, I appreciate everybody pulling up. It's been another great podcast episode. We will be back with more sports and news. But until then, it's FYF Sports, man. And we out. Really, man.